Good morning, everybody. It's 7 a.m. on Monday, May 9th. Today in Baton Rouge, expect to see sunny skies with a high of 93. Coming up on OTB, we have a new edition of Weekend Winners at 8 a.m. and Hold the Mayo joins the show at 9:15 for some spread lines. You can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at OTB_ESPN or watch us on YouTube at the 104.5 ESPN channel and subscribe for daily content. Hour number one of Off the Bench, live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge studio, starts now. Here we go.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert.
Yeah!
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, T, they said I gotta come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo.
Yo, what is up, everyone? And happy belated Mother's Day to all the moms yesterday. Hope you all had a wonderful day. Today, I will be your mother as I guide you through the beautiful sports weekend that was an underdog-filled weekend, boys, in literally almost every single sport. It seems like led by our boy Rich Strike, 80-1, second longest odds in Derby race history. They've run 148 of these things. Do y'all know what year the only longer odds horse to win this race was?
I'm going to say it's for sure 1918.
Ooh, actually shockingly close. Shockingly close. Mario, who you got?
1912.
Even closer. 19. Damn, I'm not giving you a guess. Sorry. 1913 was the last time that a longer odds horse won. It was, I think it was like 91-1. But either way, just absolutely insane story. It was Donnerill back in 1932. 110 years later, the second biggest upset in Kentucky Derby history. And the story, which we will get to later during Weekend Winners, is deeper and crazier than you can possibly imagine in terms of what this horse was bought for, when he got into the race. And so look forward to that, because what Rich Strike did this weekend should give you hope for anything in your life, right? I mean, I hope that you can do anything, just like this LSU baseball team did. And that's where we're going to start today. We're going to start with LSU whooping up on the Tide in Tuscaloosa. But before we do, welcome in the team here. Make sure everybody's feeling good. Jake, what's up, dude? How are you feeling?
I'm feeling great.
And a happy belated birthday.
Thank you.
To Jake Hester. We celebrated Saturday, but turned... had his actual birthday yesterday.
Yeah. Late 30s.
Yep.
Officially in the late 30s, but I feel great. Maybe it's false enthusiasm. I don't know. Feel great today, though.
Well, we're doing all these push-ups in between segments, so we're just out here getting swole, pumping endorphins, Arnold style. I can't use the pumping iron quote on air, but if you know, you know. Yeah. Mario, what's up with you, dude? How you feeling? You are especially chipper on this Monday morning.
Feeling good, man. Slept good last night.
Okay.
Hester was happy on his birthday. Shout out to Hester. Mom was happy yesterday on Mother's Day. Life is pretty good, man. Going to be a great week.
And Mario had the OTB sporting moment of the weekend when we were playing Sandy Shuffle, and it looked like Kevin and Jake were going to run away with it. It was me, Mario, and Danny versus Kevin, Huey Rivers' husband, and Jake.
Yep.
And they were up 2-1. We had barely won one game. There was a massive lead in the third, and all of a sudden, one round opened up where we had a chance to steal it. But Mario was up. Somebody had to take the final shot. They had to hit a three. I said, who wants it? Mario said, give me the puck. What did he do? He hit the three, and he tied the series at 2-2. We never got to play the fifth game, unfortunately. Right. But still, Mario, you kept us alive. That was a huge moment. Very proud of
you. Weekend winner, Mario.
The fact that he asked for the puck is the key detail there.
It is.
I did not want it. Danny did not want it. Mario did. He said, give me the ball. Let me shoot the rock. And then he hit the game winning three.
Did you score any points for your team?
I had like one good shot, maybe. I was not very good at Sandy Shuffle. It's a very hard game. It's a very, very hard game.
I'm pretty sure Kevin played professionally at some point.
Yeah. Kevin was spectacular as well. Yeah, for real. Chill out, Mr. JaVale McGee.
Bro. Mario said that?
You're getting carried to rings.
But who? There was one person that scored a six all night long. It was one person.
You did make it six. You did make it. Look, JaVale McGee's made some plays, too. I'm
he
not
never
saying.
Made three. He never made three. Well, maybe. He's
made some plays. NBA playoffs getting a little frisky as well, right? Some things that we thought, some series that we thought were decided, all of a sudden have completely flipped on their head.
Is there a bigger sport where the playoffs are that much better than the regular season more than the NBA?
I know
the playoffs always go up in every sport, but like regular season compared to NBA playoffs is so drastically different.
I think it's funny because these sports emulate each other in so many ways. I think hockey is the only other one, right? That like they are the
two. Good one. Yeah, you're actually right.
You play a ton of games. They're both up and down and fast paced and everything. But when the playoffs come, it just ratchets up to a completely different level. Danny, how are you feeling this morning, man?
I feel great. One night celebrating with the Team OTB.
Yeah. Weekend winner, Danny, for showing up. Proud of you. Proud of you for sure. It was nice to have you there.
I always show up to everything.
I almost assumed for sure that you were going to be nowhere to be found, be MIA at dinner and the bar, so you made it to
I'm not going
to
lie, though. Katie and I got there on time, and we sat there, and it's like 20 minutes went by, and I'm like, so...
That was not a great look, as literally everybody meeting up for dinner had different reasons for being 20 minutes late. Like it's not like everybody was somewhere beforehand. Danny was coming in from New Orleans. I was leaving the Kentucky Derby party at Don Juan. Shout out for them for having us out there. Doing a 2.5-hour stream based on the Kentucky Derby was very interesting, given that we know nothing about horse racing. But huge shout out to Don Juan for having us out there. It was a ton of fun nonetheless. And then I can't remember what Rivers – whatever. We made it, though. Made it, had a great meal at the end, and then had a really good time at a Radio Bar, actually. The radio guys at Radio Bar, how appropriate, dude.
They didn't put that together until just now.
Really?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, wow. You know what I like about it, too? It was a bar where a mix of all ages, but you did not feel old. You know what I'm saying? Very appropriate, too, on the late 30s birthday.
Like looking around like, all right.
Yeah, didn't feel out of place. Didn't feel out of place. And then Rivers and Katie started spinning up the old early 2000s hits, and it was like we were transported back to college once again. But let's start talking a little sports, because in theory, this is a sports show. How about them Tigers, dude? Taking care of the Tide once again and just furthering the love that I have for this baseball team. And that's the thing, man. If I had to choose a single word to sum up this weekend of baseball, it would be response, right? Responding to adversity. Now, the Friday night game was sick. It was a classic, right? 6-5, very tense down the stretch. LSU's pin needed 4 innings of scoreless work at the end to get that huge game one to kind of set the tone. And we can dive into game one alone, but it's almost what happens after it that starts to fascinate me, because then we learn that Jacob Berry has a hairline fracture of his finger, which is still really upsetting, and I'm very interested to see where that ends up going. But now, so you get that news during the day, so he all of a sudden is out of the lineup. Then a game two just starts. It's an utter disaster. I mean, everything that could, well, actually, I guess it's not true. Cruz did start it off with a home run to like dead center. But after that, everything that could go wrong did go wrong, right? Money just did not have it at all. There were errors all over the place, throwing the ball away. All of a sudden, I think it was 5-1 in the second inning, maybe up to like 7-1 by the fourth. It was just one of those awful games where you knew you were dead like 30 minutes into the game, which is always, always miserable. And so all of a sudden, it felt like the entire series had flipped on its head. But then Sunday, LSU day, put the gold jerseys on and the big sticks engaged. And like, to me, that's how you prove that you're not just a good team or a solid team like in Alabama, but that you are a regional and potential national seed, because you're on the road in a hostile environment. And you show up in the biggest moment and you play your best baseball of the weekend. And in the end, it means that you win this very important series where two of your starters didn't even make it out of the first inning. Think about that. Two of your starters did not even make it out of the first, and you still take this series off the Tide.
Yeah, and they've been doing it all season long, and you're exactly right. Like, we know that the pitching right now, as far as this, you know, beginning in the rotation and where it's at right now, is obviously something that's still troublesome and still worrisome for this LSU baseball team, but you can't say enough about the guys that have come in. Like, even Ty Floyd on the game that they lost, like, that's going to gain a lot of confidence for Ty Floyd.
He pitched
four innings, struck out five, only gave up one. And so the bullpen on this team, yeah, you might not have it in starters, but you certainly have it in the bullpen. I mean, Jacob Hasty, yet again, comes in and gives you four innings. It's just like time and time again, this bullpen has really been a savior. And, if this team had one more frontline starter, I mean, who knows what we'd be talking about. But you still, like, you can't worry about that. You can just worry about the guys that have come in. And so, yeah, the story is you had two starts that didn't get out of the first inning. But with the bullpen the way they have, and those guys are just bulldogs, man. They come in and they get the job done.
Yeah, you mentioned Jacob Hasty. He would be my performer of the weekend on the mound, because in game one on Friday, remember, in that eighth inning, that was definitely probably his highest leverage moment of the entire season. Alabama had a man on first. He's staring down a full count. And, I mean, the breaking ball that he threw just absolutely looks like it rolls off of a table. Batter completely fooled. And it was so aggressively in how it dropped that ends up hitting the dirt, right? And what it results in is a strike him out, throw him out. So up one run, desperately needing game one on the road in Friday. Hasty shows up, gets the strike him out, throw him out done, sets you up for the win. Then, as Jake said on Sunday, when your starter and Dutton just didn't have it, second day in a row, the starter's pulled in inning number one. Hasty comes in and gives you those four scoreless innings. And I like that he was rewarded with a win as well. I mean, Jacob Hasty's emergence out of nowhere for this team, especially with the Javon Coleman lefty injury earlier on this year. It's been like we talk about Mikhail Hilliard from a pitching standpoint really being the one that has made everything on this team work. As far as the pen is concerned, Hasty's emergence has been critical for the second half of the season and for this recent run of success that LSU's been on in the SEC.
Yeah, look at the bullpen. I mean, you look at Hasty, Raisman, Cooper, Fontenot, Gervais. It's just time and time again. And you could throw Grant Taylor in there as well, because he's kind of been that combination starter on Sunday, but he's been the second person of that rotation. So this, I mean, you have so many options that you can go down there and you can trust. And it is not ideal with what you have as far as starting rotation, certainly on Saturday and Sunday. But when you have that much trust and you know that they can keep you in the game, even if you get behind the eight ball just a little bit, they can keep you in the game. And you know you have this offense that can score all these runs. And if they just hold point, you still have an opportunity to win. It's a unique situation in the fact that they don't have somebody right now on Saturday and Sundays, but they also have so many pieces in the bullpen. I would not be shocked to see Saturday become kind of what Sunday is. And we said that last week as well.
Why? I wonder why. Yeah, I mean, look, and the money thing is interesting, right? Because this is a game in which there was already a lot of talk about Blake Money, and you continue to start him. Maybe you give him a little break. You switch it up. You bring in maybe like a Hasty or a Collins starts the game, and then you bring in Money. Yeah. They did continue to start him. And it started awfully. I mean, four balls off the bat, first batter, four ball walk. Ends up with three walks in the first inning. Out of those three walks, only threw one strike. And then ends up getting pulled. And really set the tone for the entire game, too, and why you end up losing that game. And so I don't know, man. I don't know if Money's going to continue as that starter in day number two.
Yeah, since the wrist injury. Like, it doesn't look like he's been able to do what he was doing earlier in the season. Like, remember, he pitched in the Houston Shriners Classic, and he was going against a good team, and he still, like, beginning of the season, looked like the Friday night guy that he had been talked about. And then he has the injury there, and it's to his throwing wrist, and it just doesn't look like he's had the same just velocity on his fastball. It didn't look like he's had the same break on his breaking pitches either.
I wonder why they went Grant Taylor on Saturday, just because we made so much of the Dutton-Taylor combination. I mean, I don't have any great insight. If anybody does in the chat, you can let us know. We haven't talked about the bats, though, right? And really,
I think probably real quick on that point, probably because Taylor's been so used to being that guy who's come in right after the starter on Sunday. So it's a role that he's familiar with, even though, like, there was no outs when he came in. Yeah. Still, he's at least been familiar with coming in for Dutton on Sundays.
And so they ended up going Taylor on Saturday. And that's another reason why Sunday felt so kind of tense, right? You didn't have the Dutton-Taylor combination that you had come to rely on. But you know why Sunday wasn't tense? Because the bats just kicked ass like they did all weekend long. And it was led
by Dylan Cruz. What a weekend for Cruz. So on Friday, because he gets walked twice, he only ends up 1-2, but he has one ribby, and that one ribby and that one hit ends up being the game winner in that sixth inning. Then on Saturday, a day when nobody's got it going, he goes 3-3, three ribbies, two home runs, and a walk. Then on Sunday, 3-6, another home run, three RBI. So over the weekend, bat 636, seven ribbies, three home runs, three walks, just dominant from LSU's the kind of number one superstar, maybe outside of Jacob Berry. And him and McManus really set the tone offensively for this team this entire weekend.
They did. And let's go to yesterday's game. And when you look at it, I love the lineup that they were able to put out there, because we hadn't seen Gavin Dugas in a very long time, right? He's been injured, yeah. And then he comes back. And where does he put him? I mean, he puts him in the leadoff spot. And one thing about Gavin Dugas this year is he has had a really good eye at the plate. He had three walks and two hits. So when your leadoff batter is getting on base five times like that, and then you move Pearson down, and you got Cruz, Doty, Thompson before Morgan, right? You're being creative in your lineup to create opportunities for some of your best hitters. Yeah. Because early in the year, and Jay's talked about it, like he had his four best hitters all right there in a row, and he didn't really like that. He wanted to split it up a little bit, and he puts Pearson at the leadoff spot, which he's done great. But Gavin Dugas, being the table setter, hitting, he was a DH, first game back in a very long time, to get on base like that five times, and then Pearson gets on base three times, and then sets it up for Dylan Cruz to be able to have three RBIs. Yeah. And so I like the lineup like that. If Gavin Dugas can come in, and certainly right now with Jacob Berry, and we don't really know what the future looks like, broken finger on his throwing hand, maybe can't even bat left-handed, right? That's kind of the latest word. So a guy like Dugas, like whatever you think, this guy still led the SEC in RBIs last year. And when one of your best hitters goes down, if you can get a guy like that back this late in the season, I mean, he might be crucial until Berry can get healthy enough.
Well, it's like you said, you talk about setting the tone in that critical game three, and I think he had like a 9-pitch walk to open that game. That is demoralizing if you are a pitcher, and, well, the bats ended up demoralizing that pitcher. I got to give a shout-out to the sexy professor. This is my buddy Scott Burns, really jacked dude, college professor. He tweets at us, Jake, as tough as it's been not having arguably the best defensive catcher in the SEC in Milazzo, McManus and Travinsky have combined to hit 271 with 12 home runs and 23 RBIs this season. Still drop off defensively, but those numbers aren't a bad offense for defense trade. And so, yes, Milazzo is incredible defensively. We all know this, but we also know that Milazzo has been a bit of an offensive black hole at times. You have stood on the offensive side of this debate in the past. Where do you stand now? If you get a healthy Milazzo back, like, can you take McManus's bat out of the lineup, or Travinsky's for that matter? They both hit very well.
Well, that will be interesting, because, like, when you look, obviously, like, if Dugas comes back, you would assume, like, if you're going to use one of those guys as a DH, like, Dugas would have to go into one of the outfield positions. So I don't know, man. When you look at, like, Travinsky was earlier in the year, then when he cooled off, here comes McManus, and he is absolutely heated up.
Yeah.
Look, for me, I understand what it is behind the plate, but when you have a guy like that who's batting eighth in your lineup, has four RBIs yesterday, and you know at any moment can lead, like a real threat.
Yeah, three home runs on the weekend, yeah, I think,
to leave the ballpark, for me, like, that's something I'm going to choose. Now, Milazzo coming in late game situations, right?
Yeah.
Say McManus gets out in the seventh inning, bring Milazzo in immediately to catch the rest of the game. If you want to pair him up with one of the pitchers because he is so good behind the plate, because maybe you like what he can do for you there, starting that game for that, yeah, you know, that part of the series,
Eddie
absolutely.
Perez.
That's a great comp. Eddie Perez.
Hey, guys just want to sit there and name random old athletes. That was basically Saturday's entire show. But, yeah, Eddie Perez.
Yeah.
The old Greg Maddux pitcher is a solid one. I never understood that as a kid, though. I was always so pissed. Because, like, dude, Javi Lopez is so good. What's going on, dude?
Yeah.
Why are they playing Eddie? But whatever. Maddux gets what he wants.
I'm trying to think. Yeah, because Brian McCann. Then you had David Ross. Was he Tim Hudson's catcher?
I don't know. I don't remember that, actually. Yeah.
Kind of same situation.
Sure. All right. So anything else on the baseball team? Again, to me, another fantastic week. And we'll take a look at the SEC standings real quick when we get back as well. But what did we say going into the weekend? If LSU goes 6-3 over these final three series, which is always the goal, right? 2-1 each weekend. But if they can do that, they will have a very good chance of being a national seed, right? Like, they're already looking like they're almost guaranteed a regional seed, unless it just absolutely craters. But the national seed is very much still in play, and they accomplished the first leg of that 6-3 by taking the series on the road in T-Town. Third road series win of the season, and Jay Johnson and all, like you mentioned the lineup. That's a great point, Jake. Like, even putting Bianco and everybody and just and leading off Dugas out of nowhere, it just seems like Jay Johnson, and it's all the grinding, I guess, and all the film watching, he just seems to have a depth of understanding of his players that is elite. And if you are a player, that's what you want, because that is a coach that you can trust that is going to put you in positions where you should thrive, right? That plays to your advantages and kind of masks your weaknesses. And shout out to Bianco as well. He had a really nice game on Sunday. I think he ended up with a couple RBI
singles. Yeah, a couple hits. He got knocked in too, I think, there in the first. And like a guy like that, a guy that, you know, last year he was a big part of the team.
Yeah.
I mean, remember there's a couple stretches last year. Yeah, where he was like one of your hottest bats. And then this year, obviously not playing as much, but still, he's the first guy out of the dugout with the boombox, and he's the leader, and he's not in the dugout in the corner pouting. And when he's called upon, like he, like you mentioned, got a couple hits yesterday.
So keep it locked right here. If you want to give any of your thoughts, we are on youtube.com/1045ESPN. Hit the like button, share the stream with your friends. More Off the Bench next.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Go to AllStarToyotaOfBatonRouge.com, AllStarToyotaOfBatonRouge.com, if you need a new vehicle. All-Star is there for you, and it's all different types, right? You want a big truck like the Tundra, smaller one like Tacoma, the 4Runner, the Highlander, like whatever you want. It's all there for you. And you all know about Toyota engineering, right? These cars hold their value now more than ever, as if you need to sell, you will not find a better time or a better deal than over there right off of Airline Highway. And whether you're buying new, maybe a Toyota certified used vehicle, well, you still have warranty, or you just want to rent for a vacation or some cheaper per day rental prices, go see Miss Lisa Sessions today. Go to AllStarToyotaBatonRouge.com.
Yeah, rentals is probably going to heat up here, right? Because you got the summertime, you got the vacations coming up. So if you need something bigger, maybe you got the volleyball, baseball tournament, you got all the equipment, and your car cannot currently fit what you need, they've got you covered for the trip, Sequoia, Sienna, whatever it might be. All-Star Toyota of BatonRouge.com.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the Jim'sFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the Jim'sFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
There it is, the extra mile, on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a five-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the one-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Monday edition of Hunt and Hill. We're going to talk Kentucky Derby for two straight hours. We probably won't talk about the Kentucky Derby. We'll talk about LSU and Alabama. But join us noon to two on Monday. It's Hunt and Hill.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, the 2022 LAB Prestige Award winner for Best Sports Radio Show, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
What's happening, y'all? Welcome back to OTB. Hope you're having a wonderful day. So we got our weekend winners coming up. We got spread lines with our guy Hold the Mayo coming up in a bit. Hope you're attacking this Monday. Having some fun on the way to work. We mentioned that we were to update the SEC standings. Right now, it appears, and not appears, LSU tied for third in the SEC. Again, think about that for a second, man. Tied for third. Like, promises made, promises delivered. Jay Johnson told you that he was going to get the most out of this LSU team. He told you that he was going to have to bring in a bunch of arms and kind of try to make this this pitching rotation work, right? He told you that, or he maybe didn't say this, but we told you that given his history, he would be able to develop these bats into something incredibly powerful, and that the combination of Cruz and Barry would be something to watch, and that this lineup 1-9 would become a murderer's row. And it did not feel like that out the gate, right? Kind of stumbled out the gate a bit. But like they've gone on to prove here as of late, this team continues to get better, continues to grow, continues to learn. They're winning these late game situations far more often now than they are losing them. And the vision of using a ton of arms, developing these hitters to maximize their potential, that vision is coming to fruition. And again, that's crazy, man. And I think part of the reason why I felt so bad early on is because we definitely did not understand who A&M and Auburn were going to be.
Right.
I mean, very nice record. I mean, A&M's 14-10 in conference. Auburn's 13-11. We thought A&M was going to be, like, literally last in the SEC West. And so that felt awful when you lost that series at the time. Now feels a little better. Also, that Sunday win against A&M, if you remember, which was a crazy kind of comeback win, that feels very good now. Avoiding that sweep, but LSU ahead of Texas A&M. I don't know how they have the tiebreaker. Maybe it's a better overall record, but at 14-10, they're only behind Tennessee and Arkansas. So it's a hell of a job by Jay Johnson and this team. And now you got, is it Ole Miss or Vandy this week?
You got Vandy this week, and then you got Ole Miss to finish it up.
So on the road in Vanderbilt?
Yep, and Vanderbilt is 5-4 in their last nine in the SEC, so not the Vanderbilt team that you thought they were going to be, certainly. They take 2 of 3 from Georgia over the weekend. He had a couple of close contests there. But look, before the season, if I would have told you, hey, you're finishing the season against Vanderbilt and Ole Miss, you probably wouldn't have had as good of a feeling as you have right now about those two series.
Yeah, no, I mean, Ole Miss is bad, it still looks like. I mean, not to say that, well, we'll get to Kentucky, right? You can always punch up in college baseball. But yeah, Vandy feels like, you know, where you maybe need one, but the problem with that is only getting one there is going to make it tough to maybe get that national seed, but we'll see. This is a team that has, oh wait, hold on. There, people are saying that Ole Miss is actually before Vanderbilt schedule wise. So well, whatever.
You know, tomato, tomato.
I agree. That's just a detail. Right.
It is Ole Miss, and then you have Ole Miss at home and then Vanderbilt on the road.
Ooh, I love that. Cause that could be setting up for a very exciting finish, right? What if you go into Vandy needing 2 of 3 to get a national seed? Like, I could definitely line up like that. You have to go to the Whistler's domain and try to emerge victorious.
The Whistler. I forgot about the Whistler. I guess we only really know about the Whistler like during the SEC tournament typically.
Yeah.
You know, oof, my God.
And look, in that series, you could argue, I mean, I don't know if LSU would be the underdogs or not. You could argue that they would, but maybe that's a good sign because underdogs, boys, underdogs were hot this weekend. I mean, and it was like, it transcended sports. It transcended the levels of sports as well. Obviously, it's led by Rich Strike, as we said, 80-1. Second longest odds ever in the 148 races of the Kentucky Derby. Speaking of Kentucky, you had Kentucky baseball taking 2 of 3 off of Tennessee. Kentucky, who entered the weekend dead last in the SEC East, takes 2 of 3 and takes a series off of Tennessee, who is now still, even losing it, 20-4 in conference. That also very long odds. You had Bevel. Remember, we talked to Large on Friday about the Canelo Bevel fight. Yeah. And it was interesting because Large basically told us that this was not going to be a cakewalk. Now it seems like, though, the general public was just accepting that this was just kind of a fight for Canelo to go and take another belt and he would move on and do what he does. But even Canelo falling to the weekend of the underdog. Danny, how are you?
Danny was not feeling great once he saw the news.
How are you feeling, Danny? When did you get the news? Were you at the bar? Did you get a live react on Saturday? Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Very depressing news.
Yeah.
He got no words.
He just assumed. Out of words.
I wonder if they do. So, I mean, I guess like maybe like a rematch gets set up now. I'm not entirely positive. But either way, only Canelo's second loss of his career, right? I mean, yeah. Mayweather was the only other one.
Yeah.
And that was a young Canelo and a maybe not prime Mayweather, but still prime-esque Mayweather. So there was no shame in losing that one. This one feels a little worse, I think, if you're a Canelo fan. Also, I'm going to go ahead and say it's probably a really bad omen for Team Mexico heading into next year's World Cup. I agree. I mean, you got to connect the dots here. Yeah.
Not even related.
Yeah, it's definitely related.
Definitely relevant as Canelo's Mexican, Danny, and Team Mexico's Mexican as well.
Yep.
Look, I'm just, Danny, if you, I can lay it all out for you, you know, if you don't accept it, that isn't my problem, okay?
So, new crest for Mexico. They need to switch it up a little bit.
Wow, weird new time crest for crest. Seems Mexico. A little panicky, doesn't it?
No, it's just, it's terrible crest.
It's not great.
I was going to say, in Mexico and Chambos, Canelo was all they had left. Look, I mean, we'll see.
That's not true at all.
We're going to see. and then even now, and I know these two are maybe not as nearly as big of underdogs because it is the NBA playoffs and what we talked about, but even the Sixers and Mavs, right, where the Sixers looked like they were completely dead in the water. Mm-hmm. Joel Embiid comes back looking like freaking Batman in the mask, looking super tight. He balls out. And then James Harden, a career that we had declared dead, right? I mean, like we were ready to put James Harden out the pasture and turn that man into glue, and then he pops off in game number 4. And now, all of a sudden, the Miami Heat, who Heat fan have been feeling themselves as of late. They rolled through round 1. It looked like they were going to roll through round 2. Now, all of a sudden, they're on the back heel going into game 5. Before we move on to Mavericks here, Mario, any thoughts on Heat Sixers?
Captain Obvious, but Joel Embiid being on the court makes a huge difference. Imagine that.
MVP.
Yeah, not just his play, but everybody else, including James Harden, seems to be kind of stepping up. So I think the Heat still win the series, but it's definitely gotten a lot more fun.
When did Tyrese Maxey get so good?
Like these playoffs?
It's like these
He had a pretty good regular season. But I know because of draft teams.
But he's turned it up even more these playoffs.
He's been solid all season long, but he's definitely – you know, raises the level of play in this postseason, to Mario's point.
So that's who won you that big payday the other day? Was he a part of that one?
No, he wasn't on that, but he's helped me out before.
Okay. He's been maximizing your DraftKings.
How do y'all feel about
I should have said maximize.
Yeah, you should have.
Damn it.
How y'all feel about Embiid in the mask? I thought he looked pretty badass.
Yeah, he does. That's what I'm saying. He looks like a superhero or like a supervillain. It's fantastic. You know what else I love too? If you want to talk about validation of the award, I love an MVP candidate returning and that much of a difference being made, right? Like, you cannot take that man's MVP award.
Yeah.
That was a team that looked awful without him, and now they look completely different the second he steps back on the court. And he's playing hurt like AF. Like, he's all kinds of banged up. I mean, playing with a broken face. I think one of his fingers.
Yeah, he's got a torn ligament in his thumb. He's like the fish from SpongeBob that's got, like, cast all over his body, and he's playing through it.
So a worthy MVP. I mean, look at that mask. I thought they weren't allowed to wear solid color black ones, because I remember LeBron had this sick carbon fiber a few years ago, and they made him take it off.
That might have to do with the Heat's color scheme. It was too much black when LeBron wore it.
See, I wish he would have gone with the carbon fiber, though. It looks just slightly tighter. But still, good on Embiid, a true MVP. And then the Mavs, who I don't know. Maybe I'm off base here by viewing the Mavs as much of an underdog as I did, but CP3 fouling out, not allowing him to be the fourth quarter force that he has been thus far. And now all of a sudden the Suns once again in a dogfight as that series is returning to Phoenix 2-2.
Well, Dallas just needed somebody other than Luka to step up. I mean, poor Luka in the first couple of games of this series, I mean, he was just by himself. And then, like, you had some guys that actually, you know, came to play. And so, like, Jason Kidd kept saying, like, in the post games, like, look, we need somebody else. Like, basically talking to his team through the media, like old Nick Saban loves to do. Like, he was like, we need somebody else, not named Luka, to step up and score some points here.
This is what it is. I couldn't place it. Craig Granger's right. He looks like Doom, like Dr. Doom from Fantastic Four. Joel Embiid does. Like, he really Photoshop a cape on that man, and it would look absolutely it'd look fantastic. Speaking of underdogs, you mentioned Rich Strike, and we'll touch on him again during weekend winners. But how about this? Do y'all know how Rich Strike was purchased back in the day? He was bought on a claiming race, which I didn't really even know what this was. But I guess I've kind of read a little bit about it. I guess it's like it's a low money race where I don't know if you have to buy the horse before or you buy them after the race, but he was bought for $30,000. $30,000. The purse at the Kentucky Derby alone for the winner was $1.86 million. It's a pretty good return on the investment there for the owner, Rick Dawson. And I love this quote from Rick Dawson after the race where he says, "What planet is this? I feel like I've been propelled somewhere. I'm not sure. This is unbelievable. I asked my trainer on the stage. I said, are you sure this is not a dream? Because it can't be true. He assured me this is real. I said, okay." And then you read about the owner, the trainer. I think the trainer had one pretty good win in his entire career, not even a top level win. The jockey had never had a top flight win. The owner never had. And now Rich Strike. And that's maybe the best part about it is the run itself.
Yes, the run itself, I think, is the best part.
It's like you can not know anything like us about horse racing and be like, dude, that was badass.
Yeah.
He came out of nowhere. Everybody else jelly leg. And then somebody tweeted this, and I think you agree. I agree. Is Rich Strike the CD Deuce of horses? I mean, you saw that man talking trash after that race, biting that dude, biting that horse, just up in his grill, letting him know, dude, letting him know. Coming from the bottom, Rich Strike.
Oh, I mean, where he was and how he had to maneuver himself, and Danny's showing the best. This is the overhead angle of it. But there's no way that Rich Strike should have won this race. I mean, he's just passing people up and finding little crevices to find a path to pass people. I mean, right here, he's blocked by like 12 horses.
He's in the box. Done for. He should be absolutely done for.
And not only like where he came from, but how fast he started to pass people once he made his move.
Yeah, there was some mile per hour stat that I can't quite remember. It was great. More on Rich Strike coming up.
Epicenter definitely thought he had. I mean, he's like, yeah, I'm good. No, you ain't.
CD Deuce coming up. Let him know. And he had a little, like, I felt like I could see him even though he's a horse, afterwards kind of slapping his chest and being like, this is my house, you know, this is me. As he's biting old boy, the little pace horse that was supposed to get him.
I can believe in that, yeah.
All right, when we get back,
Hey, wolves like to be alpha, so can horses, right?
Yes.
The bench with Hester and T-Bob.
No, dude, I think that is a very real thing. These, like, mega racehorses have, like, they have personalities that, well, it's just proven. It's just absolutely proven. And you can see that horse preening, like, the alpha that he was after getting that dub. Speaking of dubs, if you have a construction company or you run a plant, your employees deserve the best. Get them a win by getting them the Tiger Air insert for their hard hat from Airflow Now. It's a tiny little insert. They call it the Tornado. You just stick it in the top of the hard hat, and for 8 hours, it basically makes you a walking AC unit. Give your employees what they deserve. Protect them from the Louisiana heat. Go to airflownow.com today.
Maybe, look. You can hear it just through the microphone. That is the air from the Tornado. Only 3.5 ounces, 8 hours, like T-Bob mentioned. So a full shift of runtime. It's waterproof. It meets and exceeds all standards. I mean, this thing's going to keep you cool. We told you it was coming. It is here. That heat from South Louisiana. Airflownow.com, airflownow.com.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
Come on over to Corval Toyota to pre-order your next vehicle. It's an easy and stress-free process. Browse, reserve, pick up, and enjoy. It's that simple. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corval Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
Service Master Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Master Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Master Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This isn't just another day, it's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who are born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
There it is. The extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
For a Monday edition of Early Line, as we talk to Jeff Sheesby of the Action Network and look ahead to the night's action in the NBA playoffs, and we recap the weekend that was. Join us for Early Line, 2 to 3 p.m., 1045 ESPN, Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Yeah, so I'm an idiot. I was assuming that Embiid was going to win MVP. Breaking news, it looks like Nikola Jokic has won MVP. I was thinking about that this morning. Mario, do we have a... Do we have a finalized NBA All-Defensive Team?
Yes, we do.
Okay, so Herb did not make it.
Nope.
Wow.
None of them.
Dude,
he got a couple votes, but he didn't make the team.
Terrible.
They're coming in his career. Don't worry.
I know. I saw Jose Alvarado tweeting about how one day he will be Defensive Player of the Year. I was like, I'm good for Alvarado, right? I mean, he is someone who has spoken a lot of truth to power. But I think Herb's probably first in line for that DPOY.
I mean, did you just break the MVP news? Like when you said it, it's like, he thinks that. Let's go ahead and break it.
It came out
right after you said that.
Hashtag breaking. I had no idea, dude. I was trying to show Embiid.
It really did,
love,
like, and multiple places, like 3-4 minutes ago. Like,
that's pretty wild, though, okay? Because those MVP awards, obviously, I mean, they matter, obviously, duh, T-Bob. But it's back-to-back for Jokic now, right?
Yep, it is back-to-back.
Like, I wonder, what is the full list of multiple MVP award winners? It is not very long. I would love to see. So Nikola Jokic joining some elite list of players there. I mean, that guarantees a Hall of Fame, basically, right? Like, there's no way that you could find me a two-time MVP that is not in the NBA Hall of Fame.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah. I'm looking at it now.
And the Basketball Hall of Fame is a little bit different than the other Hall of Fames.
Wait, how so?
Just like it's the Basketball Hall of Fame. It's not like,
in other words, Marbury.
Yeah, it's like the Naismith. Yeah.
Like Marbury playing in China could get Hall of Fame consideration for what he did in China.
Oh,
as an right. NBA. Yes. That really helps his argument.
Yeah.
I used to love Stephon Marbury back in the day, dude. Hide those kicks.
Dude, no doubt about it. Georgia Tech had a great haircut.
He
had the Starberries, no doubt. We've talked about that.
And then he had I think they made a musical based off his life in China.
He's got a statue.
Which I still would love to see a Chinese sung and acted life story of Stephon Marbury. Shout out to the, who do you play for? The Shanghai Sharks?
Oh, I think so.
I have no idea. I guess.
I know Jimmer Fredette played for them.
Shout out Jimmer.
Yeah.
Pelicans great. We had Jimmer Fredette in studio back in the day.
Did you really?
Yeah, 3WL trying to, I don't know, get excited about Jimmer. I used to hate that dude. I used to talk about the Pelicans so much on air. The only people they ever gave me was Jimmer Fredette in studio and Norris Cole over the phone. Oh, and I got Alexia Jensa one time.
Norris Cole
on the phone. And it was one of the worst interviews ever. He cut it off in the middle because he's like, I got to go to practice. I'm like, what? Like, screw you, dude. And then they gifted us a Norris Cole signed shoe. And I want to say a Dante Cunningham signed shoe. And I was just like, all right, dude,
wow,
whatever.
Do the Pelicans hate you?
I mean, I felt like they were actively trolling me. It was ridiculous. It was ridiculous. But we also know that AD wasn't doing anything like that. He wasn't going to come on nobody's show or do anything like that. It's fine. New era of Pelicans basketball. All right, we're going to go short here, and a little short we get back, and then we're kicking off hour number two with weekend winners. Keep it locked right here on Off the Bench. Hit the
Off
like
the
button.
Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hit the like button and hit your life with something to like. If you go to ITI Technical College right here in Baton Rouge, if you want a better life, you literally want to change your life, go with the school that Georgetown in a study dictates is the best investment you could make in the entire state. Top 15 in the country. In terms of money you pay for the school versus what you can be expected to make 10, 20, 30, 40 years down the road. It takes just 1 to 2 years to get that AOS degree. Flexible scheduling works around you. And remember, it is Baton Rouge, family-owned, local campus here in BR. iticollege.edu.
All right, call this number, 225-267-8003. That is the number you need to call. That is our number that you can let them know that OTB sent you. And once you call that number, remember, they will work with you. They're going to work around your schedule. They're going to make sure that you get to the finish line. Nobody else is going to do that. 225-267-8003.
Our listeners fire up their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s, plus $500 bonus cash. We have new 2022 F-150s on our lot now. And all new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
I've been doing business with Luber for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
And this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA certified techs. Family owned and operated by the Sherman family for 30 years, Front to Back is the answer in Baton Rouge for all of your custom boat needs. So head to fronttobackboatservice.com or find them on Facebook, Front to Back Boat Service.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Scona wishing all the moms a happy Mother's Day weekend and inviting you to join us for Monday's AFR presented by Relief Windows. We'll recap LSU-Bama from Tuscaloosa. Join us Monday, 3 to 6, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
What's going on, y'all? John Cormier says, sounds like an awfully good topic for animal facts. What animal facts are you talking about?
Wait a minute. T-Bob, it's going to pique your interest. Animal facts.
Yeah. No, I guess we were... Okay, so somebody asked a question about how many... horsepower does actually like does one horse make like how much horsepower did Rich Strike put out as he was striking at Rich? I'm not sure. We'll have to look that up. Craig Granger, we got weekend winners coming up to start hour number two. Craig Granger's at hashtag weekend winners. Chase Elliott for once again hooking it up with free fried pickles at Hooters for another top five finish. Wait, so that might be.
I love that.
I was about to say, that is one of the most wholesome and excellent promos I've ever heard. So how's that work? If Chris Elliott finishes top five, or Chase Elliott, if Chase Elliott finishes top five, just everybody gets an order of free fried pickles at Hooters?
I
feels
guess
like
so.
Pretty extreme, dude. You have to be a part of like the Hooters club or something?
I mean, be still my redneck heart.
I'm saying like if I just...
Hey, if y'all see that bull guy? Fried pickles, Bo.
That's what I'm saying. If I walk into Hooters today and ask for fried pickles, do I get them for free? It seems like they might take a bath on that a little bit, dude. That's a lot of pickles to give away.
I mean, pickles aren't the most expensive food, and you know, flour, you just, you know, whatever, throw them in the grease.
This is a really out of nowhere comment. Ultimate Warrior saying, I'm going to gain 10 pounds this week. I finally tried cotton candy ice cream. It's so freaking delicious.
Is that Hudson Hester?
What? First off, I don't know that I think cotton candy ice cream sounds very good.
It's a lot.
It feels like a lot. That's what I'm saying. And a lot to the point where, sure, maybe a bite or two, but if you like it so much that you're going to gain 10 pounds this week at Ultimate, that's pretty extreme, dude. Oh, here we go. Shout out Rhonda. Danny, no, long time no see, Rhonda. Sorry that you and Danny hasn't been returning your calls. But Rhonda says, former LSU Tigers Taryn Clough and Kristen Nuss won the Austin AVP tournament.
They did. They are out there.
We need to have back on this week. We gotta stay in there. Like, we gotta stay top of mind with them.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
That way we can be the, we get that invite to the Olympics when it happens. Go to Go
Chose.
That's what I'm saying. So we have to. Well, I'm back on this week to celebrate then for sure. Go to GoChoseOutdoorPower.com. GoChoseOutdoorPower.com. What if that person really is named Rhonda? They're like, what are you talking about? Go Chose Outdoor Power. They're local, family owned by Shane Gocho. Started this thing 18 years ago when he noticed that he just wasn't getting the service that he deserved from these dealerships. And so he decided to make it easy for his customers, and they do. Free delivery anywhere in the state. You're listening up at 11:30 a.m. the Tiger in Shreveport. They got you. Okay.
Alexandria. And,
yep,
they got you.
Yep, 94.7 in Alexandria.
New Orleans.
Absolutely. Yep, 100.3. And free access to the service department, the full access to the parts department when you buy from GoChos. It's just so easy. GoChosOutdoorPower.com. Once again, it's GoChosOutdoorPower.com.
We make it easy.
There it is, the extra mile. On the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Kids have staked out their place at Ochsner Medical Complex, The Grove, where more than 30 pediatricians and pediatric specialists are all conveniently located under one roof, so you can spend less time driving and more time keeping your kids well.
Dibs!
It's no wonder kids call dibs at The Grove. Ochsner Health Center for Children.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Bayou Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram has new 2022 Ram 1500 Bighorns in stock with 0% for 72 months. Shop our inventory or custom order your Ram with $2,000 bonus cash and a 1,000,000-mile warranty. The crew at Bayou is going to do right by you.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Good morning, people. It's 8 a.m. on Monday, May 9th. Today in Baton Rouge, expect to see sunny skies with a high of 93. If you missed hour one of the show, you can now catch that up at the on-demand section at 1045ESPN.com. Coming up on OTB, we have a new edition of Weekend Winners coming up next, and Hold the Mayo joins the show at 9:15 for some weekly spread lines. You can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at OTB_ESPN, or watch us on YouTube at the 1045ESPN channel and subscribe for daily content. Hour number two of Off the Bench, live from the Mercedes-Benz Baton Rouge studio, starts now. Let me go!
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert.
Yeah!
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, they said I gotta come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo, yo, yo.
What's happening, y'all? Welcome back to OTB. Hour number two beginning right now. If you're watching on YouTube.com/1045ESPN, put your weekend winners in the chat. We'll break them all down. I'm trying to find some hard numbers on Dr. Strange right now. I just thought about it. I want to see what the box office there, because I'm sure they probably belong in weekend winners. Also, Strange 2, the first Marvel movie in a long time where I'm actually kind of really excited to rewatch it. Like, I don't think I'm going to go back out to theaters because I don't have to do the whole babysitter thing. But, like, I'm like, when it comes back on, you know, Disney Plus or whatever, that will be a day one rewatch for me. It kind of juiced me up once again. So, a winner in that regard. Like I said, get them in the chat. If you're driving to work, let's have some fun over this next hour. Yeah, let's just dive into it, man. Here's another edition of Weekend Winners.
That's how winning is done.
That's right. We can't have anyone freak out there, okay? We've got to keep our composure. We've got too far.
I'm by winning. I win here and I win there. Now what?
Are you doing what it takes to win a championship?
Wow, winning.
Well, then I guess there's only one thing left to do.
What's that?
Win the whole thing.
All right, we'll start with the most obvious one. And that is... Rich strike. Striking it rich. We talked about him all morning long. It's a type of sports story that the truth is stranger the fiction type of story, right? It's like you could make a movie off of this race alone, because chances are, I don't know what he's going to do next, but you could make a movie off this. So I've been saving a couple facts, but I'll run through some ones that you might have heard earlier. Again, 80-1, biggest winner since 1913. You know, second of all time. Last one's 1913, 110 years later. He was purchased in a $30,000 claiming race. The purse alone for this race was $1.86 million. Did y'all know that he was not even supposed to run? He was an alternate, right? He was an alternate. So if anybody scratched, he was going to get in. And they were actually told, so the deadline was 9 a.m. on Friday to set the field. They were told they were not racing. The security guard told them to leave the barn. Like, literally, that, like, was throwing them out the club. Said, you have to leave the barn, and then with 10 minutes till that deadline, Ethereal Road ends up scratching. They get put in, so they move from the 21st horse to 20th, the last horse in, and then they go on, and they win in that manner. Just unbelievable, an incredible highlight. Like, if you ever played Derby Owners Club, my favorite arcade game of all time, you know that feeling of being a stretch runner. It's the most fun. It reminded me of the Fast and the Furious, right? You can never blow your NOS too early, like Epicenter and everybody else did. And then I would say the sub-winner in all of this, outside of, like, the owner and trainer and jockey and all that, is Larry Colmus, who is on the call for NBC. Danny, do we have this video ready to roll with audio? Okay, here we go. This is Rich Strike's incredible run for the Roses.
Zozos is next after three quarters in 1:10.45, and now Epicenter comes splitting horses and is moving up quickly as Crown Pride takes the lead around the far turn. It is Crown Pride battling with Messier. They're stride for stride. Epicenter and Zozos in behind them. Cyberknife swings up on the outside. Sandon gets the rail run, and they're into the stretch. And it's Messier, Crown Pride, and Epicenter is coming up on the outside. Javis Center has taken the lead as they arrive into the final furlong. Sandin is coming after him. Epicenter and Sandin, these two, stride for stride. Simplification down the outside is next. They're coming down to the wire. Epicenter, Sandin, Rich Strike is coming up on the inside. Oh my goodness, the longest shot has won the Kentucky Derby. Zozos is next after three quarters.
I have in 1 minute. That, in my hair right now.
That man never said Rich Strike until about...
When it happened, like
literally the finish line? Not one time did he say that man's name.
Well, and it's crazy even though the horse was making a run, like you had such a battle for first place.
I tell a couple of the favorites. I tell people this all the time when they're like, oh, Mario, you didn't see that block. You're a play-by-play guy. You got to watch the ball. That's tough to see Rich Strike coming from that far away.
Well, and you're also expecting at that point, it looked like it was a two-horse race. And like, even if somebody's making a run, there's no way they're going to run down the two leaders.
The first two guys are in a dead heat.
Like, I would say typically in horse racing, like they'll mention like, real quickly, like, and Rich Strike's on the outside, but who cares because we're going back to here.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Didn't even, like, he's not even here. Like,
and and you could hear that in Larry's voice when he sounded incredulous. When he said Rich Strike, he was like, whoa, what? Like, what is going on here out of nowhere? Good on him for immediately knowing who it was, though, and that was the longest stop. Just, of course, he should know, but still, like, There were people who had no idea, like most of us, who that was when they ended up getting the win. So Rich Strike, just unbelievable, man. The shot is beautiful. Great production. Great everything. A great derby. And now we just got to hope that there's no, like, Rich Strike bad news or anything like that comes out next. Also, I would say let him run. Some people are saying just immediately retire him because your value will never get higher.
Right.
But, like, what is his value still? It's higher than it was for sure, but people are still going to doubt him from a studying standpoint, I'm sure. So, like, I say let him run and let's see where this fairy tale goes.
Dude. So you want him, like, in Louisiana Downs, basically like the musician that's going to the casino tour there on the Gulf Coast. You want him going, like, Louisiana Downs and be, like,
I want him to do at least the Triple Crown. Like, go for at least go for the Triple Crown, and then after the next race, when you don't win, because it's probably not going to happen, then that's fine.
Okay. No, that's fair. Danny, is that ready to go? Okay, let me set this up. Okay, so y'all know I'm an Everton fan. Y'all know I'm an Evertonian. Y'all also know y'all heard us talk about them being in the relegation zone. Well, let me tell you, this happened. Now, it's not done, but Burnley loses, right? Leeds United loses. You know who didn't lose over the weekend? That was Everton, and they were away. They were at King Power Stadium. They were playing Leicester City, and had 3,000 away fans, 3,000 Evertonians at this match. And on the TV broadcast, you did not hear Leicester's fans. You heard the Evertonians, 3,000 in the corner of the stadium. They go and they get a massive 3 points. Everton saying, look, nothing but the best is good enough. Well, this was the best. The Evertonians are the best. This was 3,000 people almost an hour after the match finished in somebody else's stadium cheering. Listen to this.
Go Blue! How long after the match was that? Because for those that are listening on the radio, there was nobody left in that stadium. Like, it was literally a completely empty stadium save for that one corner.
And so normally when you have an away team like that, like, they'll let the home team get out first and then the away team will get out later. But this was like 20, 30, 40 minutes after the match. They never stopped cheering. Frank Lampard, the manager, he comes out and he's like blown away by it. And obviously they start hamming it up for him as well. Super Frank chance. It was a great scene. The Evertonians they do not care where you're at on the table. It's what makes it so great. It's what makes fans like this fantastic. In some sports, you don't even go to the away match when your team is in, at the beginning of the match, 18th place out of 20. But they go, they're loud, and now Everton, as of today, is not in the relegation zone.
No, Blue, and look, man, if that doesn't tell you why college football should adopt the relegation model, nothing will. Like, there should be no if this was the NFL, there would be no Everton fans there because it would not matter. Like, it would just be a crappy season and only the most crazy and diehards would have showed up. There'd be no tension, be no excitement in beating Leicester City. And yet, it feels like you've, like, won a championship or something. And we know a college football Super League is coming. That feels inevitable. as things stand now. And so I hope. Now, I don't see why the ruling powers that be would ever agree to this, because nobody wants to get relegated. But that would be one of, I think, the craziest and best developments for college football as it enters this very new and wild era where everything is changing. If they would really just, you know, nut up and adopt a relegation model, dude, it'd be great. Well, I mean, and look, it's so flexible, right? You could have 30 teams, you could have 40, you could have 20, like whatever the case may be. Do it, college football. Really do it. All right, who we got? What's next?
So if I could bring it back to the Derby for a second. Had a lot of celebrities out. And Martin Brundle works for Sky Sports. Apparently, he's a former F1 racer, and he was trying to get interviews with some of the celebrities. And if Danny's got this video ready, he thought he was talking to Patrick Mahomes, but he was not talking to Patrick Mahomes. Here's the video.
This is crazy. I've never been to an F1 race. This is spectacular.
It's amazing to be allowed right in the middle of the competitors just before the race starts.
Yeah, now you can see they locked in. It reminds me of myself. But the real focus.
Okay, it's not Patrick. That's why he ignored me in the beginning. But what is your name, sir?
Paolo Banchero.
Right, okay. Well, I thought I was talking to somebody else. So I'm sorry about that. Whatever.
Yeah, there's no way he still knows who Paolo Banchero is, even after
that. Who is that?
It might be the first pick in the NBA draft.
Oh, okay.
Duke.
Oh, okay, that makes sense, though.
You didn't know who that was either?
No, bro. I would have been right there with Brundle. Guys, y'all know I don't give a damn about college basketball.
Dude,
I don't know how many times I have to tell you.
They were in the championship. Well, the semifinal.
The Final Four, yeah.
Yeah.
I was watching. Wow, college basketball guy, huh? Maybe you should remember that Duke didn't make the championship. Duh, Mario. It was kind of a big deal. They lost to UNC. Coach K, do you remember that?
I was there. I'm aware.
Wow.
But yeah, that was cringe as hell. And that's not the only time he messed up. He didn't know who Serena Williams was either.
No, that's inexcusable because he's a worldly, like he's a, yeah. You know, he's like
Serena
he's not
Williams
from America.
Is a worldwide superstar.
Right? Yes.
You can't mess that one up.
Also,
and in like in person, like she is like, you know, she is an uber talented athlete, like world class athlete.
Yeah,
like there's no denying it. Like as soon as you see her in person, like, oh, that's a world class athlete.
That's what I'm saying. I saw her walking into the Kentucky Derby and she was just looking like athletic.
Oh, she's in a shape like shape you've never seen before.
But I do like that he called himself out on it, right? Like he could have just, as soon as he said focus, he could have been like, all right. And then like just turned around. He was like, I thought you were Patrick. Okay, my bad, dude. Well, you have a great day. You have a great day.
Hey, I kind of like that. He's like, oh, about your pattern. All right, see you later.
Yeah, I mean, okay, if we're being completely honest, I could see a bit of a funhouse mirror effect. They kind of look similar in a way. I mean,
that man is how many inches taller than
Patrick
Mahomes?
No, that's why I say funhouse mirror. He's like stretched out, like stretched taller.
No, come on, man. No, they don't even look like they're like second cousins.
Where's he from? Australia? Where's this dude from?
Got to be England, I believe.
Okay. Well, yeah, there you go, man.
The boy,
Scott Sports,
he works in England. I don't know where he's from. Yeah.
Well, it's either way, it's American football. The Serena thing's inexcusable, but whatever. Interviewing a bunch of random people would be very tough.
Nobody wanted to talk to him. I was watching that live. Like, none of the celebrities wanted to talk to him because he was just walking around like, can I talk to you?
Well, and that sucks. Like, I hate that to begin with, right? Yeah. And that is one of those jobs where you have to really put yourself out there and you have to be open to just getting rejected constantly. And it just feels really bad. You go ahead and loop that music, Mark, because we are far from done with weekend winners. Danny, do you have a weekend winner?
Yeah, whoever decided to shut down the legendary Scuttlebutt and Slidell, weekend loser.
Yes,
legends
Danny.
Never die. Scuttlebutt lives on forever.
This made weekend winners.
So I have not. I many people were shocked by this. I had never even heard of Scuttlebutt before all this. So give me a little primer. What was Scuttlebutt? Why was it so beloved, and why will it be missed so much?
It's a gentleman's club. It's very bright pink, and everybody sees it when driving past Slidell. Like it's like huge billboard, and like everybody sees it. It's just
that makes
that
sense.
Huge massive sign right there.
I don't drive past Slidell much, but rip to Scuttlebutt. Danny, have you ever been to Scuttlebutt?
I've never been.
So has anybody ever been to Scuttlebutt in the room, Mario?
No.
Yes.
Hey!
Long time ago.
Hey, Mario!
Before it died. Shout
Let's
out.
Go, dude. How was it?
It was pretty subpar, not gonna lie.
I mean, you know, So what you're saying is it looks like the picture. It was like the picture of the building that we just saw.
Yeah, in prime time, like on Saturday night when I went. Maybe I just went on a bad night, and it was like 6 years ago. But
no,
yeah.
I mean, Saturday night's generally the time to go to gentlemen's clubs. But it does make you think, what does the day shift at Scuttlebutt feel like? either way, rip to the butt. It's almost got so much juice that I would not be surprised if somebody came in and bought it and just kind of tried to remake it again because it went a little viral. All right, I'm up once again. Danny, look at the Tony Ferguson picture because over the weekend winner, I couldn't find the photographer's name, but one of the greatest sports pictures of all time as Michael Chandler knocks out Tony Ferguson with a leg kick. I mean, look at that. If you're looking online, he turned Tony Ferguson. Somebody said he turned him into Abe Lincoln.
That's yeah, Abe Lincoln is definitely what I saw too.
To me, he looks like a caveman with like that drooping lower lip. Like, blah, blah, blah. And I mean, this gives you an appreciation of the power. I mean, look at Michael Chandler's quads, bro.
Yeah.
Danny, look at that.
That's intimidating to Danny. Come on.
Burn that into your brain, Danny. That's what your quads could be looking like, but you playing. Okay? When you want to get serious, you too could leg kick someone back to the Stone Age. I mean, unreal, dude. Shout out whoever took the picture. Shout out Michael Chandler.
Weekend winner for me, and T, if you want to piggyback on this, I know you had it as well. Kentucky baseball.
Yeah, man.
Kentucky baseball gave Tennessee their first series loss in SEC play, which is incredible for Tennessee, but even more incredible for Kentucky, and Kentucky had to have it. Kentucky, before the weekend started, was not in the SEC tournament. Now they are in the SEC tournament if the season ended today. Now, they still got a long way to go. Missouri and Mississippi State, by the way, might miss the SEC tournament.
Wow.
The defending national champion might miss the SEC tournament. Kentucky went out there. They walked them off. They showed some grit. Kentucky baseball had no chance to even take any games off Tennessee. They take 2 of 3. Again, they played inspired baseball. They knew they had to have the win. They go out there, and they do it. And y'all know, look, Kentucky, like I root for Kentucky. Let's go.
Yeah, it. Yeah, you do have. It's kind of like me with Mississippi State a little bit. You have a little bit of a Kentucky soft spot.
I do. And Mitch Barnhart, give my man Mark Stoops some extra years to figure it out. They figured it out. And not Kentucky basketball. Nah, that's a whole different thing.
Who doesn't love angry Tony Vitella as well? Screw you, Tony. Tony B. Hey, Tennessee, you're gonna blow it, Tennessee. Like, I hope any Tennessee fans listening start to spread the word amongst your friends because all of this is going to be for naught. All of this, the same way that Arkansas, well, actually, and it was funny, Arkansas actually had a better season last year than Tennessee did this year. Arkansas didn't lose a series. Tennessee now cannot claim that.
And Arkansas, remember, didn't even get to Omaha.
Yeah, exactly. Tennessee's not going to either. It's going to be so much fun to drink in those delicious Volunteers.
I hope we play Tennessee again just so T-Bob and their fans can go at it again.
Jake just gave me a handshake for that pun in case you missed it. Did you even pick it up, Mario? Volunteers?
No,
I
did.
Drink there. That was good. On the spot, boys.
Yeah, I'll give you a golf clap.
That's not even a dap. That's a handshake.
What do you got, Mario? Weekend winner?
Yes, weekend loser, actually. So I don't know if y'all are watching the 76ers game, but there was a fan sitting courtside who basically took a nap mid-game.
Courtside?
Yeah. He did. I think this guy's kind of a busta for sleeping, you know, in a very critical playoff game. But I also think it's kind of a power move to have courtside seats and take a little mid-game nap, get refreshed for the fourth quarter when it counts.
Yeah, this dude is I get a very degenerate.
Did you see him after the game, though?
So I'm, like, super hyped up, going crazy. Yeah. No, this dude feels like he looks like he gets into some greasy stuff, man. Like this dude is not sleeping because he stayed up late working on a project for work. This dude has made all of his money already, and he stayed up late doing other things, and that's what ended up getting him.
There's a messed up story about the Menendez brothers. I don't know if y'all have heard of them.
Yeah.
You just gave me a look like something horrifying happened.
Because I thought of that. And these brothers were serial killers, and eventually they were caught. But a few weeks before they were caught, they were seated courtside in an NBA playoff game.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was just talking about maybe like he was like doing coke and going to Scuttlebutt. You think he was? He's too fat.
I never said that. It just reminded me of it.
I think he's probably too fat to be murdering people.
I would think so too.
It'd be like a lot of work.
But to Hester's point, he was turned up by the end of the game.
He was.
So like I said, he was kind of conserving his energy.
Yeah. Big Cat had before coffee, after coffee this morning. It was a great tweet.
He just needed a little tiger snooze. That's all he needed.
Yeah.
Danny, you got anything else?
Max Verstappen wins his first ever Formula One.
Okay.
Is that true?
Yeah, he wins his first ever.
Are you sure? He's won the championship, I'm pretty sure. I think
he won
the first Miami. Miami Grand Prix. Verstappen takes it home.
That's what I meant, yeah.
No, so I told you, I'm watching Drive to Survive right now, and it's fascinating because in season number one, Verstappen is the young prodigy for Red Bull, and they're kind of all in on him and making him happen, and then come to find out he actually happened. Like, he is that rare prodigy that came through and followed through in
the
biggest way.
Check that out.
Last one here.
I've got one more, too.
I did a picture earlier with Tony Ferguson. We're going to do another picture here with the four goats. As here's one of the most powerful pictures you'll ever see in sports. It's Lewis Hamilton, Michael Jordan, Tom Brady, and David Beckham all at the Miami Grand Prix, which I know Kentucky Derby normally has like superstars at it, but F1 still takes the cake when it comes to bringing out the big money
it's
people.
It's on a heater too.
Yeah. Yeah, no doubt. Sports, they're about to get a new TV heater. Contract. Yeah. It's going to be huge. David Beckham also punching up here. Good for Beckham.
Yeah, yeah.
Great player.
Yeah, yeah.
Great player. But you were talking about the unquestioned greatest of all, like the literal goats
in
the other three guys. So nice job by David Beckham getting in that crew.
Without question. I mean, David Beckham, great player, but I just think if Ronaldo was in this.
Yes, Ronaldo would have been, or Messi, I think, would have been the correct
David
answer.
Beckham's way better than we were. So.
There. Yes, that is fair to say. David Beckham was better at soccer than team off the bench.
Better than us. Yeah. All right, my last weekend winner. I got to give a shout out to my three boys that play baseball. Hudson, Knox, and Memphis.
Oh, okay.
They were sick over the weekend. I mean, Hudson looked like a ghost. I mean, he was like barely can make it through warm-ups. And like, I was like, look, you can't. Like, I don't think you can go out there. Like, I don't think you can play.
You were ready to pull him.
And his team didn't have enough players. They were either going to have to go with like two outfielders or no catcher or whatever. I mean, he's white as a ghost. You know, we got ice on him. It's like, you know, he's sick, whatever. He sees that his team doesn't have enough players. He goes out there, makes three plays at third base, gets an RBI double.
Oh, wow.
Really rose to the occasion. And then Memphis had two hits. He was playing sick, makes an out at first base and looking six-year-old baseball. And out at first base. Okay, look.
Like he caught it or threw it?
Look, grounder. He catches it, steps on the base. Look, six-year-old baseball. Look, y'all know that's a big deal. And then my man Knox, same thing. They move him up from the end of the lineup to cleanup spot. He's sick.
Okay,
he's sick
dude,
too. It's like, look, hey, Knox, they're moving you up in the lineup, man. You got 4-game hitting streak. You gotta, you know, do you want to go? He's like, I'll go. Gets a hit. Actually, gets hit his first time up to bat. Not feeling good. Gets hit right in the ankle. But then he comes up. He gets a hit. Shout out to the Bull Reds. They got their first victory of the season as well.
Three Jordan flu games.
They did. I was proud of him, man. And look, I wasn't trying to force him to play. I'm like, can you go? Do you want to go? All three of them are like, we can do it.
Okay,
we'll go out there, and they all played well, and their teams won.
I'll hop on this train. My daughter's soccer team remains horrible. We lose every single game, 30-40.
If y'all
to
saw these videos, they got kids taller than me and T-Bob out there.
I don't understand.
Who put this together?
I do not understand the age limits on this soccer league, but whatever.
I am 12.
Mario, we'll show you the video during the break.
A dude did a pullback on my daughter. I'm like, what are we doing here? She has to take 30 seconds to line up a kick, but only six people showed up.
That's right.
Only four could play at a time. Halfway through the game, all the kids were crying. Nobody wanted to play. And I told Alice, I took her aside, I said, look, girl, you just got to go. And she didn't score. She didn't do anything particularly impressive, but she ran the entire time. And ran hard, and she was dog tired afterwards in that heat. And I was a very proud moment.
Right.
But yeah, we lost like 40-0 again. I hate this soccer league.
You ever seen bench warmers when the guy hands him the piece of paper, I am 12? That's what this soccer league is. I don't know who in the world's charge of this deal, but shout out to Alice because she did run the entire
time.
Some
of the angles on these finishes, what the heck, man? All right, are we done? We're done? All right, very fun, very long
25 minutes,
winners.
I love that.
When we get back, more off the bench, keep it locked.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Go to allstartoyotabatonrouge.com, allstartoyotabatonrouge.com. Look, man, no matter what you and your family needs, my vehicle standard, can you turn that down a little bit more? It seems a little loud. All-Star Toyota, they got you, man. And it's not just buying a new car. There's also buying a Toyota Certified Used Vehicle where you get that Toyota warranty where it's very easy. You just bring your car in. It's all already paid for. You're good to go. They check up, extend the life of it. It's also if you need to lease a vehicle, right? That's how I ended up in the Camry. Unfortunately, you know, family car died out of nowhere. I'm like, man, it's kind of tough right now. Like, I have a number. What can you get me? And they found an answer for me. Then that is the thing, right? It can be very overwhelming, the car purchasing process. But the answers are there for you at allstartoyota@batonrouge.com.
Now, the tree law, the full fleet is available. It is in every process that they offer, the full fleet. Check it out today, allstartoyota@batonrouge.com.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
ITI's got all these programs. Once I started and learned everything about the school, it was worth it.
The challenges that ITI presented me with, it allowed me to build myself up.
All because of ITI, I actually was able to get a job within 3 months before graduation in my field.
Get the hands-on training you need for the job you've always wanted.
With so many companies hiring right now, it's the perfect time to come to ITI Technical College.
Enroll today for a better life.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
There it is, the extra mile, on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a five-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the one star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Monday edition of Hunt and Hill. We're going to talk Kentucky Derby for two straight hours. We probably won't talk about the Kentucky Derby. We'll talk about LSU and Alabama. But join us noon to two on Monday. It's Hunt and Hill.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Esther and T-Bob, the 2022 LAB Prestige Award winner for Best Sports Radio Show. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Welcome back, OTB. Danny Dev, you seen Strange 2 yet? No. Mar, you didn't see it over the weekend, did you?
Look, until Danny plays Pat Benatar's Love is a Battlefield, I'm not talking to him.
Yeah.
I've been asking for 4 days.
A lot. He has been asking for multiple days.
I mean, I'm sure, I don't know this to be factual, Danny, but I'm sure it's got a quite banger of a video. It's an 80s song. It had great videos.
All right, so it looks like the second Doctor Strange, which this is pretty wild given two things. First off, given what's going on in the box office right now, because
it's a weird time.
We all know how bummed we were when Northman just feels like it absolutely flopped, and we thought it was tight.
Massive
kind of flopped. I still wonder what Massive Talent has done since, but
I'm looking right now.
They're going to be tough to make up those numbers.
The Northman with a budget, what did we say, 70 million?
It was somewhere 70 and 90s.
So there. 3 weeks in, it's only made 28 million.
Ah.
Unbearable Weight of a Massive Talent. I believe the budget was.
Wasn't like 30 or 60?
30.
30?
It was 28, something like that. In 3 weeks, it's made 16.4.
What?
Now, that is a movie.
Nobody's seen Massive Talent. What is going on, guys?
And these movies both, remember, they rated very well. Like on Rotten Tomatoes, with critics, everywhere, they rated extremely well. Now, Massive Talent and Northman, I think, will make some money. Northman won't ever get to it, $70 million. Massive Talent might, because of the intrigue of it, like once it goes to streaming and stuff, it'll make up some money there. But
even that's a failure.
Even that's a failure.
Break even in Hollywood is not break even. Like,
what are we doing?
I don't know, man. And help me out, Danny. Those aren't both A24 joints, right? I believe only Northman's A24. It's a bummer because it feels like this was a big bet from A24.
But Sonic's made $170 million.
I mean, well, that's
Sonic
like,
actually wasn't that bad. But
I've actually heard Sonic 2's all right. I'm intrigued enough where I'm going to watch it pretty soon here. But yeah, that I guess the disappointing part about that is some animated movie, what maybe called like The Bad Guys or something.
Yeah, it's made $60
million. Yeah. It like dominated the box office weekend in which Northman and Massive Talent came out. But that sucks because I don't feel like A24 normally does budgets that big. And they went for it
and they
on
won't
Northman.
Anymore, probably.
Yeah, exactly, right? Or like, and it's what a bummer for Eggers. It's just being acclaimed your best film. Yeah,
now, let me ask
Critical
you, yeah.
Darling.
Let me ask you this. If now you want to make money, money's the name of the game. But as a director, you don't make money. But, I mean, the ratings and everybody, the critics and everybody's really talked it up. And maybe, like, down the road, maybe you win or you're nominated for something or whatever it might be. Like, does that make it better, though? The fact that everybody is well-received, the audiences just didn't go see it.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's like, I can't speak from, like, an educated standpoint. I would imagine that
well, I mean, when do we?
It's, yeah, exactly. Right. It's never stumped us
when
before.
When do we?
It's not as bad as it not being good though, right? Like or it's like the real disaster would be it doesn't make money and people think it sucks.
I guess my question would be if it made $50 million but it was awful in the opening weekend.
Oh, like which would they prefer?
Yeah, I guess. Sorry, I didn't set that up.
I think the I was also kind of I was reading a comment, so I think I was a bit distracted. I think
no,
that,
that was an awful assist by
okay,
me.
Okay, so I think that. The bottom line marketing, obviously, and like the CFO would probably take the money, but I do feel you because A24 tracks are they do a lot of business due to their creative goodwill, right? Like people go in and they expect a quality, interesting, a bit off kilter movie when they go see an A24 film. And even though Northman didn't make the money, it has upheld that reputation.
Yeah,
it has only deepened that reputation that they make good. Out there movies, which Men is starting to get a little juice as well, dude. And that looks so scary and so good. And I love Alex Garland. And Ex Machina is one of my favorite movies that I've ever seen in my entire life. Like, that's a top. Actually, Danny, now, two of my top five movies of all time are A24. Because Ex Machina is in that number and Everything Everywhere All at Once is in that number.
And that's actually made some money over the last couple of weeks, I guess, because just like you probably went and saw it a little bit later.
Yeah.
And it's really got some juice because I think the totals for Everything Everywhere All at Once is, 42 million in 7 weeks. It's still making 3.3 million. So it made more than The Northman, Massive Talent, Memory of Liam Neeson movie that came out that flopped as well, and Father Stew, a Mark Wahlberg movie that flopped. A lot of stuff, man.
The Father Stew. The Father's New preview looks so stupid.
I don't even know. Yeah, I'm like, it was just I like Mark Wahlberg, but
I think what was he like
it's seven. It's seven on IMDb though.
Oh, that's a damn good IMDb. But isn't he like a priest that maybe goes on some sort of revenge killing rampage? Danny, what is it?
I think it's a boxer turned priest.
It's a Christian movie, right?
Oh, a boxer turned priest.
He was a boxer, smoker, whatever, and then he turns into.
I saw in the preview he was trying to be an actor as well.
Something like that.
I don't know. Either way, you know what?
That's an HBO Max one for me.
I was about to say, I actually guessed that my brain never got past seeing Mark Wahlberg with the white collar on and just thinking that was funny. Like, just seeing that alone. Anyway, Doctor Strange opened at $265 million in the international box office, and it's already past $450 million. Globally, and everything over all at once, I want to say, Jake, was made for about $20 million. So I'm pretty sure you can call that an unqualified success now.
Without question, it doubled
in budget, and it was so highly rated. I mean, think about that. A movie making over $40 million where the lead is a Chinese-American woman that runs a laundromat. That is not typically Hollywood success right there. And that's where Strange is maybe a bit interesting, is that it's not Spider-Man. It's not some of these bigger names. It requires almost homework to have the deepest appreciation of it with WandaVision and some of these other episodes. And yet, hey, man, Marvel plays. And I don't know. Like I said, I think it's kind of made me excited for Marvel movies again. What's the next one that is out? Is it Thor?
Thor, yeah.
Which, dude. Thor Ragnarok's, you know, one of our favorites. Bringing back the same director, obviously. It's going to be tough. It'll be tough to follow up Ragnarok.
Yeah, exactly. Right? Taika Waititi, like we mentioned with Raimi the other day, you could feel the Raimi in Strange 2. You can feel the Waititi in these Thor movies. But and that's rare that Marvel and Disney trust a director enough to let him do that.
They also got a new screenshot with Natalie Portman.
Yeah. Oh, bro, she looked jacked in the one preview that we saw. She looks jacked right here. Like, that is a markedly different Natalie Portman than Black Swan Natalie Portman. Like, she's been doing them chain workouts with Thor. Holding Mjolnir just fine, dude. Wow.
All right, so I'm thinking this is how. So y'all know we all, as a team, went and saw Massive Talent. I'm pretty sure that our schedule coming up, and y'all tell me if there's one that, like, y'all are out. Because I know, like, Jurassic World, you're out on that, T-Bob.
I mean, the boys are down.
No, look.
I mean, I want to see Jurassic World too. I guess I never saw the second one, actually, so I don't know.
We've got May 27th. We've got Top Gun Maverick. Yeah. That's a no-doubter.
We're all going to that.
What about Lightyear, June 17th? We in on that?
Lightyear we looks can bring pretty the kids? Tight, dude. I'm down to do a kids' day for that, for
okay,
sure.
Y'all are coming too. Sorry. You don't have any choice.
Danny, Rhonda, she was here earlier.
Yeah, for sure.
That's correct.
And then the next weekend, Elvis. I'm like, y'all are coming regardless.
Yes, from a team bonding standpoint, yeah. We need to do Elvis because just for Jake.
Yeah,
for the homies.
Like, and then Thor comes out in July.
Come out, all y'all have to come.
I'll go without question.
All right. I think we got a pretty good run. Boy, the movies are back, baby. Let's go, dude. And we will be back after this break. More off the bench.
If you give me that
off the bench
sign,
with Hester and T-Bob.
Go to DGBAuto.com. He did try to sneak the brake sign where Jake couldn't.
Like
see
if
it.
Your motorcycle needs work, it can go to DGB. That's fine, but his motorcycle sign needs some work.
Yeah, I guess you could bring a motorcycle in there. I hadn't really thought about that. DGBAuto.com, DGBAuto.com. Dossel Glass and Body. Remember, if you're in a situation, perish, you get an accident, the police cannot tell you who gets to tow. You say DGB, you're going to get $100 off those towing fees. And then you're going to go to the best body shop in the state. And it's not just collision repair, man. Oil change, wheels, brakes, tires. Like, your one-stop shop down there in Deville. Yep. DonaldsClassandBody.com.
Hey, now, Deville. They've helped T-Bob out. Look, I mean, he had a car that it was on his last leg, and then, like, Donaldsville Glass and Body was able to keep it going. Like, y'all know me. Like, I've got a car that's got 125,000 miles. They've worked on it. I'm still on the road every single day. Don't have to worry about it. It's reliable because they worked on it. DonaldsvilleGlassandBody.com, DGBAuto.com.
Our listeners fire up their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge. Follow us on Twitter at 1045ESPN to cast your vote in the Citizens Bank and Trust poll of the day. Vote daily inside Off the Bench, Hunt and Hill, The Early Line. And after further review, Citizens Bank and Trust brings you the poll of the day via Twitter at 1045ESPN.
Bayou Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram has new 2022 Ram 1500 Bighorns in stock with 0% for 72 months. Shop our inventory or custom order your Ram with $2,000 bonus cash and a 1,000,000-mile warranty. The crew at Bayou is going to do right by you.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
For a Monday edition of Early Line, as we talk to Jeff Sheesby of the Action Network and look ahead to the night's action in the NBA playoffs, and we recap the weekend that was. Join us for Early Line, 2 to 3 p.m., 104.5 ESPN, Baton Rouge.
You leave this house now! Just forget about coming back.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Many questions about what we just witnessed. We just witnessed Pat Benatar getting kicked out of the house. So is that her little brother that she was staring at longingly through the window?
I mean, it looked like it.
Okay, yes, because there does appear to be an age difference.
Yeah.
And I wasn't sure, but why is it called, like, Love is a Battle? I thought,
Look, all I know is the song's a banger. The video looks great so far.
Yeah, it looks like maybe she's going to be a lady of the night out of need.
I mean, it's telling a story. That's for sure.
Kicked her out of the home.
Yeah.
Her father's dealing with deep regrets as he stares dejectedly into his macaroni. I wonder what Pat did to get kicked onto the streets. This is pre-cell phones, too. How's he going to get in touch with her?
I mean, Pat Benatar, very underrated.
I don't like this. She's falling in with a bad crowd. As we're watching now, she's in some sort of smoky nightclub, and there appears to be some sort of pimp looking at her with predatory vision. Pat, get out of there. Go home.
Is there like a play-by-play of
you and your father can make up, I promise. That dude's jacked.
Look at the ball guy with the cigarette and glasses.
I think, I'm not saying we have to keep playing this, but I do think I need to see how this video ends. So whether that's like when we get back or at the end of this segment, I need to know what happens to Pat. I'm very nervous for her in this video. This is a hot song. And you know who's on a heater right now? Coach Kim Mulkey, the LSU Badgers. So we're going to talk to Coach Mulkey coming up
Wednesday
at 8:30. I texted her last night, and she said she is back in Texas with the grandbabies. I got a life question, though, here. Was I wrong for this? I told her to, when we booked it, you told me she's grandkids, I told her to kiss those grandbabies, which I feel like normally is something that only the older person is allowed to say to the younger person.
No.
In fact, Coach Mulkey's told me multiple times, you know, kiss them babies.
Kiss them babies, Bob.
Yeah, exactly, right? So I was like, okay, I'm going to flip the script. I'm going to jump on this, and I'm going to be like the wise older one being like, hey, make sure to kiss some grandbabies.
I think that's completely Southern of
okay,
you.
Cool. All right, yeah, cool.
At least I do. I mean, I don't know. Boys, how you feel? I feel like it's okay. I don't know.
Sure.
Yeah.
Mario's got probably some sort of, I don't know. Let's see what Mario
says. No, I'm with it. I can see why in that setting it would be awkward, but no, I agree.
Why? Oh, awkward? You asked Jay Johnson, hey, coach, so why is it a manager in the Major League Baseball ranks?
And he gave a good, detailed answer.
I'm sure Coach Mulkey appreciated it.
He did. That is still, well, that's maybe why I wasn't sure, because all I got back was a thanks with a period. And if that was a younger person sending thanks with a period, that's a bit of a red flag, right? But
Yeah. Sometimes
I do feel that, older texters, they're a little more invested in punctuation, and you know, they don't want to, she has so much going on, she doesn't want to sit there and type out like, well, she has to, I don't know. I just didn't know if I maybe stepped over a line telling coach to kiss those grandbabies as if she didn't know
I think
to
you're
kiss
good.
Those grandbabies.
Yeah, I mean, you know to kiss your babies, but she tells you, and
that's
you
fair.
Appreciate it.
Okay, that's a good point. That's a good point.
I think that is just very Southern of both of you, and I'm all here for that.
Okay, because I've been thinking about it a lot. Ever since. So what did Coach Mulkey do to re-enter the headlines here?
Mario, number one transfer from?
Maryland.
Yeah, Mario unironically said Maryland. I thought it was a joke, but no.
Angel
Mario
Reese
said,
from Maryland. Or that, Maryland, if you're Mario.
Is that how you pronounce Maryland?
Like 80% of the time, yeah.
Wow, okay. So number one transfer in the country?
The number one. And no surprise, really no surprise, but they've been like on a heater getting obviously high school recruits, getting who they needed through the transfer portal. And that's why we kept saying like, man, we're blown away in year one that this team is where they're at. I mean, they hosted NCAA tournament games. And look, I realize that they didn't make the run that they wanted to, but what they did in the SEC, they were the second best team in the SEC. They pushed the national champ, right? Remember, like that game was fantastic. They pushed South Carolina. And that was just really off, you know, trying to piece together this team. It was parts of the old team and tried to rush parts of the new team. And now this is about to be a team where it's under Kim Mulkey's full mold. They are crushing it. Just like men's basketball is doing right now, women's basketball is doing maybe even better.
Yeah. And it's, you have Nick Saban out there recruiting. Mac Mann's done a hell of a job, but Kim Mulkey is up there with, you know, the greatest to ever do it. And now, as you always point out, Jake, now has the season one success to sell. Promises, actual proof in the proverbial pudding.
Yeah, you've got a transfer from West Virginia. You've got one from Ohio State. Now you get this one from Maryland. Doing some big things.
All right, when we get back, let's close that out. Number two of OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
You know we have to come back with the second half of that Pat Benatar video now next, yep. So I can know if Pat ends up all right. Let's go to GEAUXroof.com. Go to GEAUXroof.com for all of your roofing needs. 927-8300 is the number. 927-8300. Why go roof? Well, a few reasons. First, they're going to give you a free professional estimate, okay? So it doesn't cost you anything up front to figure out exactly what's going on. Then, of course, everybody's going to be licensed, bonded, and insured that works on your roof. But then how about this? You want to talk about standing by their work for the customer? 2-year workmanship guarantee on top of the manufacturer warranty, okay? So not only do you get a beautiful new roof every single time, but you also have that peace of mind that the work will be quality and the work will stand the test of time. So if you think you have any roofing issues, call up, get that free estimate, 927-8300. Go roof!
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Service Master Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Master Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Master Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s, plus $500 bonus cash. We have new 2022 F-150s on our lot now. And all new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
And this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA certified techs. Family of
Atmoscona wishing all the moms a happy Mother's Day weekend and inviting you to join us for Monday's AFR presented by Relief Windows. We'll recap LSU Bama from Tuscaloosa. Join us Monday, 3 to 6, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
I've been trying to tell y'all for a week.
I mean,
a lot of storyline here.
On Pat Benatar, she entered the horrid, sordid nightclub environment. It appears she became a part of a prostitute troupe. She has now led, to my best guess, judging from the video, she has led a revolution of the people as the courtesans have stood up to their pimp. They are rebelling against the ladies of the night. Pat Benatar is leading the charge and they're saying, no, this is our time now. Oh no, but now the pimp is dancing back at Pat Benatar. A fight back attempt.
Love a good dance battle.
There's no way he's going to be able to stand up to Pat.
Y'all know I'm all in on Step Up movies.
Oh, she just threw water in his face and walked away angrily. He stalks after and puts his hands on her. So that 17-year-old did last night to CP3's family. I don't know, reportedly. That's what everybody keeps saying, but nobody has a video of it. That a 17-year-old high school kid put his hands on CP3's family last night. A kid sitting in the second row. His mom, on Mother's Day, had to escort him from the building. Yeah, they got kicked out.
Good on his mom, by the way. Like, that has to be so embarrassing for that to happen.
And what she was going to do, leave him? I don't know about good on him.
But still, she was guiding him away. I thought she did the right thing.
What is she going to do? I mean, you don't really have a choice.
You remember the guy, Russell Westbrook, and his dad got into it? Or the kid and his dad who got into it with Russell Westbrook? It could have been handled worse, trust me. She did a good job.
Oh, it looks like Pat Benatar has freed the ladies.
Yep.
As they've emerged into the sun from the smoky nightclub. They all hugged it out, and now Pat is walking away. Will she get home? Find out in hour number three of OTB.
It's over.
It's over?
Yeah.
What a cliffhanger. So we don't know if Pat ever made it home.
I don't know if home was the objective, T-Bob.
You're right. She made it out of a bad situation, though.
Yep.
And she freed her fellow prostitutes. Hell yeah. Way to go, Pat Benatar. What a video. Legendary. Love is indeed a battlefield. When we get back, spread lines. Hold the Mayo was at Jazz Fest.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Did y'all see the soft shell crab po' boy that dude ate? Oh my God. That thing, I had dreams about that thing last night. And I can't wait to hear from Hold the Mayo directly. Yeah, that's actually not an exaggeration. I saw it right before I went to bed, and so it did end up my dream. Go to RejuveMeMedical.com. Restore me, refuel me. Rejuve-me. We're out here getting swole, trying to feel young once again. Jake just entered the late 30s. Well, guess what? I don't care if you're 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s. Rejuve-me Medical is there for you. They will draw your labs, see what your body needs, and customize a comprehensive plan for you to feel better. Once again, go to RejuveMedical.com.
Once you go there, you will see what we talk about every single day, conditions they treat. It's right there on the homepage. Fatigue and insomnia, mood and memory problems, sexual dysfunction, weight gain, whatever it might be, they can help you. And you got to call them first, right? 225-230-4201. Get that plan together. RejuveMeMedical.com.
Come on over to Corvall Toyota to pre-order your next vehicle, and you'll never pay over MSRP. Browse, reserve, pick up, and enjoy. It's that simple. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corvall Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
Light beer shouldn't taste like water. It should taste like beer. More taste, 96 calories. Miller Lite.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
There it is, the extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play. With safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team. And backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Good morning. It's 9 a.m. on Monday, May 9th. Today in Baton Rouge, expect to see sunny skies with a high of 93. If you missed hours one or two of the show, you can now catch that up at the on-demand section at 1045ESPN.com. Still to come on OTBOT, Hold the Mayo joins the show at 9:15 for some spread lines. You can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at OTB_ESPN or watch us on YouTube at the 1045ESPN channel and subscribe for daily content. OTBOT, live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge studio, starts now.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert. Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, they said I got to come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo, yo, yo.
Happening time. Bilbo Baggins saying that a troop of prostitutes would be a prostitroop. Like a gaggle of geese, a pride of lions, a murder of crows. What are the other good animal herd names? Does anybody have anyone else? Mario?
From the River Parish Disposal, the crocodile is called a congregation.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, crocodiles are called a congregation.
Okay, now you're jogging something in my memory. Being on radio, I listened to a lot of, I heard that a lot, I feel like, back in the day. Okay, anybody in the chat, if you've got any more, let me know. That'll be our animal fun fact for the day. Welcome back to hour three of Off the Bench. We got Hold the Mayo coming up next. Wait, what's up, Danny? You got one?
What? No, I was anything.
Oh, okay, sorry. I saw the mic move over there, and I thought maybe, yeah, I don't know. Mark, that was a weird signal,
no,
right?
No, Danny just shamed me for having his mic off, and then he doesn't have anything to say. Like,
what? Danny, bro, come on, dude. What? Why'd you want to say? What do you want to say?
Nothing. The moment passed.
Do you have an animal herd thing? Was it like a joke on animal herd?
You were talking about the River Parish Disposal commercial on WWL.
Yeah.
I was saying Deke Bilivio, right? He was the voice of that.
Yeah, he definitely did a lot of those reads, yeah.
Okay, not the one that I'm thinking of, but yes. Yeah, for sure. Our garbage, what is it?
Your business stinks, something.
Yeah,
our business stinks, but it's picking up.
Yeah, it's a great, I mean, hey, as far as jingles go, credit where credit's due, right? Yeah. It works on so many different levels. You're a trash company, so it quite literally is stinky. It literally is picking up. It's a successful business. It's really well done there. All right, so coming up this hour, we got spread lines coming up with our guy, Hold the Mayo. As he was out there and at Jazz Fest this weekend, he was also partying with Mincy late into the night. We'll get breakdowns of both of those things. I believe he has a tarot reading as well for Jake here. Chill out. I know it's tarot, but I'll never forget our guy Devin saying that you know, he's trying to talk to some girl. Next thing you know, he's getting taroted. Danny, does that go on? Like, I see a little bit of this. I know, like, Ricky Williams is super into horoscopes. Like, in the single man dating scene, and maybe you're into horoscopes, Danny. I don't know. Do you find that you run a lot? You run across a lot of astrologically inclined females.
Definitely. Yeah, I feel like every girl in her 20s is into horoscopes, but they don't do tarot card readings, but definitely into horoscopes.
Is this a recent thing, though? This astrological or zoological? Because, like, I don't remember this being that big of a deal. Like, sure, my sister's Cosmopolitan magazines that I used to read sometimes as a growing boy for no reason in particular. Those Cosmos sometimes would have, you know, horoscope sections, or every month they would. But I don't feel like when I was in high school or anything, people were going around talking about Sagittarius and Taurus and whatnot.
Yeah, I guess it's like a social media thing.
Huh.
That it's gotten more popular.
So do you have to have a working knowledge of it in order to communicate with the girl? Like, do you just have to have, like, enough to be like, oh, yeah, I know. Yeah. I mean, I heard Mars is in retrograde. Yeah. It's big news. Big news for us all. Like, what do you do? How do you handle that situation? Because you can't, or do you just act like you don't care?
I mean, no. I go along with it. I play along with it. I actually care.
I read this morning that...
What do you have? Do you have like a daily horoscope app, and so you can just kind of get a primer for the day and just kind of rinse and repeat whatever you heard?
I'm not on that level yet, but you definitely gave me a new idea. Like, I'm definitely gonna download that.
Yeah, that's absolutely what you should do. Download your daily horoscope app And if nothing else, you'll have one. It's like when we do water cooler facts on the show, right?
Yeah.
Like, you know nothing about the subject, but we're going to give you a few things to spout out to your friends. You can sound somewhat informed. You just need a water cooler horoscope app, Danny, and you will be good to go. Emil, who not Emil's single anymore, but he has. Well, yeah, why did you say you were going to fight Emil?
Throwing shades. Like, that Elvis chair looks terrible. He's like, that he tried to. I don't even know if we can say this yet, but he said something about Tom Hanks's accent. Colonel Parker was German American. That's what the accent is.
I know, but it is, but it is weird though.
You can get canceled too, T-Bob.
No. Okay, well, first off, if we're being full true circle here, we didn't really like the preview until we saw it on the big screen.
It was better on the big screen.
It played markedly better on the big screen than it did on the small screen. I think the other worry was like, how's this actor going to do? But what did Elvis's,
Priscilla Presley said that that's as close to Elvis as ever, that has ever been on screen.
Okay. I mean, that you literally could not get a bigger supporter or a better statement on that. So maybe that assuages a bit of that. The thing is, I think Tom Hanks is just so recognizable that it feels like Tom Hanks in a fat suit doing a German accent, which is exactly what it is. But, yeah. but you know what I'm saying, yeah. Right? Yeah. Like, maybe, I don't know if they needed to go like, maybe they should have gone like the full. Or like Colin Farrell is completely unrecognizable at Penguin because they made him completely unrecognizable. So I'm not expecting any like in Bruges accents or anything, but we'll see. Look, the trailer on the big screen at least got me like excited to see it. It looks pretty epic in scope. And just out of friendship, and Jake, how many times have you been to Graceland?
13.
13 times. So out of friendship and brotherhood, something that Danny doesn't know about, but we're explaining every single day. We're bringing him in. We will go to
you
Elvis
keep bailing together. On everything. What do you mean?
No. We're not doing this again. I'm not doing this dance again.
So you were trying on. To start it with me.
On. I'm just moving on right now. No, because I'm telling the truth and you're not, is my point. Okay. So, yeah. How about Dan Orlovsky, dude? Pretty high on the New Orleans Saints. Our boy saying that they're maybe the most slept on team in the entire NFL and could challenge the Bucs for the division this year.
He had them, what was it the other day? Third best team in the NFC?
Yep, right behind
LA and Tampa.
Yeah. Yeah. And then I think Green Bay even ranking behind because they lost Devontae Adams.
I think it was the day after that Tyron signed, if I'm not mistaken, right? Okay. So obviously that adds some juice there, but. Like you said it the other day, Orlovsky was on a heater last year. Matthew Stafford and Joe Burrow were his guys before the year. They ended up playing each other in the Super Bowl.
Yeah. And, let's hope that that heater continues. I see it, man. It's going to come down to Jameis because I think the defense, is this fair to say? Because expectation's a hell of a thing. Is it a disappointment if this Saints defense is not considered a top five defense in the entire NFL by the end of the year?
Yeah.
I know that's a very high bar.
I think so, though.
But they have a huge collection of talent, and they have heavily invested in that side of the ball.
No, I think so. I think when you look at who they have, three edge rushers that are talented enough to be first-round selections, right? And Peyton Turner, you still got to see what you're going to get there. Obviously, his rookie year was riddled with injury. You look at the linebacker position, like Pete Warner last year when he had to play, played extremely well. That's a second-round talent that showed you a lot last year, and we know what DeMario Davis can give you. The defensive backfield, which was the biggest question mark, you have now signed a top free agent, actually two top free agents, in May and Tyron, right? So you get two top free agents there. You draft a second-round corner that has the ability to play corner and safety. You get Roby back on a very team-friendly deal. There's a lot to like about the Saints defense. I mean, you still got Onyemata there rushing the passer from the defensive tackle position, Sherrod Tuttle. So you have talent at every position. And offensively, you went in the draft and you spent two first-round picks on your two biggest weaknesses.
Bill Bobagin says, how's one of the top organizations in the NFL slept on? Because you're in the post-Peyton era.
Yeah, and Breeze.
Yes, you are in the post-Peyton and Breeze era, and it is really that simple. Although, we need to bring this up. We'll get this for next segment or after Hold the Mayo, but I want to say Dennis Allen had some very praiseworthy quotes about Jameis Winston the other day, basically talking about, why is my voice just dying as the segment goes on? But about Winston and his work ethic and Jameis being one of the hardest working people that he's ever coached, and that this is a guy who just studies and lives and breathes football 24/7, which is the exact obsessive nature that you need from somebody who's going to be an elite quarterback. Yeah. And sounds like someone who for the last couple of years has gone to, I mean, remember it was Jameis that called playing under Drew, like going to quarterback graduate school or yeah. like quarterback college or something right. along those lines. That's essentially what he's been doing. So we will see.
Sony Michel also visiting the Saints is big news. Sony Michel, somebody obviously first round selection, has had moments in the NFL, just won a Super Bowl with the Rams. If you're able to sign him on a discounted deal, yeah. certainly if AK is going to miss any time, he's got RB1 qualities, right? That helps that position. And then even when Kamara comes back,
like, yeah, I mean, who's that's better a player that can help you. Michel. At this point, it's probably Sony, right?
Probably at this point in his career,
yeah.
yes.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not saying that Sony's ever reached the heights in Ingram, right. certainly not. But Ingram like kind of burst last year, but then I think his age kind of caught up with him a bit as he was asked to do more and more as the season went on. Scott Dice says the New Orleans Breakers beat the Houston Gamblers. There's a couple Breakers comments that I've seen today, Mario. How is your bet looking that the Breakers will win more games than the New Orleans Saints? What's the Breakers record right now?
They're 3-1. I think okay. we need to alter that to maybe winning percentage.
Wow, dude. No altering.
Already backing
they
out.
They play because, less games.
Yeah, I know, but that's kind of the point of the entire bet. That drastically, that was the nature of your take.
Nah, they're still doing really good. They only lost one close game to Birmingham, which is the one team that actually has a home field advantage.
Yeah, that's so stupid, dude. Whatever. Enjoy this one year. I might get a couple.
Have we got a look at the ratings, TV ratings? I mean, they're pushing it. It's on, like, NBC, not NBC Sports, not CNBC. It's on NBC, and it's on, like, Fox. So, then,
I know it burst
if you don't
out of the
perform
gate.
On those networks, you're not going to perform.
I know that it burst out of the gates, but then...
I mean, everyone who has a TV has access to those channels. Even if you don't have yeah. anything hooked up, you can have antennas on top of it, and you're going to get those channels.
Yeah, I haven't heard much about it since. We will see. Coming up next here on OTB, we will see what the Cards have to say for Jake as he celebrates a birthday yesterday, and we will see everything else going on with our guy Hold the Mayo on Spread Lines. Keep it locked here on OTB.
OTB. OT.
Go to AccutempBR.com. AccutempBR.com. For all your AC, heating, and electrical needs, you want to go to Accutemp. Why? Because you'll get service to the highest degree. And boys, while it remains nice and the evening right now, the heat's here, right? I mean, we all felt that this weekend. It has arrived.
Tag team back again, yes.
Yes. We knew it was coming. It was inevitable. Yep. And which is why we've been trying to tell you to take advantage of AccuTip for these last couple of months. But if anything goes wrong, you know that AC unit cannot stay on the kibosh. So you go to AccuTempBR.com, schedule online, very easy. Very enjoyable. The customer experience is second to none.
Look, you don't want to be that guy, like that you didn't get your air checked out before the summer came, and then all of a sudden it goes out, and you're in trouble, more than trouble. Like, you're probably not sleeping at the house. Don't be that guy. Make sure you go ahead, get your AC checked out, because that heat is here. Become a star member like T-Bob and I, AccutempBR.com.
Our listeners fire up their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
House call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
ServiceMaster Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact ServiceMaster Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. ServiceMaster Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Monday edition of Hunt and Hill. We're going to talk Kentucky Derby for two straight hours. We probably won't talk about the Kentucky Derby. We'll talk about LSU and Alabama. But join us noon to two on Monday. It's Hunt and Hill.
OTB OT with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
One of the all-time rock band bangers right here.
Yep. Ooh, that'd be a good segment. Top guitar hero / rock band bangers. Message in
be
a bottle.
Be a good tier list.
Yep. Message in a bottle. It's almost tier list season,
yeah,
boys.
I'm about to say.
It's almost tier list season.
I know. I said that the other day.
Do we wait till after baseball, I guess, is the question.
I mean, used to wait to tier list like January through May.
Yeah, but, you know, I think that did lead to a little bit of burnout amongst the crew.
It did.
By the end, nobody was suggesting anything. We're getting lazy with it. The science was getting sloppy.
Yeah.
We're going to bring it back. Just like every week, we bring back our guy, the legend, Hold the Mayo, Devin Snow. New Orleans' finest, greatest city in the world, RB&R Day, greatest tradition in the world, greatest New Orleanian in the world. Hold the Mayo, what's up, bro?
Let's go, baby. Happy birthday, Jacob Hester. May 8th, right?
Yes, yep. Sir. Thanks, sir. Yesterday, May 8th.
Is it time to tear at him? Go ahead and give him a little tear reading here.
Great news. And, T-Bob, I don't even think it's called carrots. I think I was wrong about that. It's just called a horoscope.
Oh, okay. I like tarot, though.
Well, I think tarot sounds tight, too. So.
Yeah, we'll keep rolling with that.
Jacob, here's your tarot. Taurus is born on May 8th are practical and intelligent.
Okay, yeah, please. Yeah, please.
They are rarely glamorous.
Okay.
And
grit, fullback.
Okay, this is my favorite line of the whole horoscope right here. This one's deep. I really felt this one. Yeah. Yet they have the opportunity to make a name for themselves by the very nature of their capableness.
Hey, I mean, that is quite literally, I mean, that is Jake's fullback life right there. Rarely glamorous, but making a name for himself due to the nature of their capableness, getting those fourth and ones. I mean, that is it right there.
That statement's strong as garlic. They have a reputation for saying what they think, whether it's critical or complimentary.
Yeah, not afraid of confrontation.
That's very true.
On the radio.
Maybe some, maybe too much.
Spouting takes. I mean, is this a big win for horoscopes? Are we are we tearing people now?
Can I say this as well? Like, we were at the Dreams Come True golf tournament whenever that was. I don't even remember. But we also did a reading as well. And there was something that you said about something big coming for me. Now, I can't get into that yet. Oh, but, like, that's in the works. And it's, like, down the stream. And it's, like, big time.
That's
all you got to do is look at the stars, baby. Everything's in the stars.
Look at that. I mean, I guess so. Danny, maybe you need to actually dive into this thing. I mean, Mayo, you've been on that single man's life as well. Are you in agreement with what Danny was saying? Like, is this something that you're running into more and more? And is it a recent development?
Yes. I think the way that y'all were talking about it's perfect because that is what's happening. It is kind of new. I think it was popular, like, in, like, the 70s or something like that. And, like, then they brought it back. Just like, you know, playing vinyls. You know, now we playing vinyls again. Well, now we bringing back horoscopes and tarot readings. And Benny hit it right on the dot. If you single in your 20s, you better be ready to get tarotted.
Tarotted.
Stay ready. Good. So, okay, already here, helping out some of our younger listeners. And look, maybe you're an older guy, fresh off a divorce, you're trying to get back in the game. It can't hurt. It can't hurt. Now, we have a bunch to get to on Spread Lines this weekend. Let's start with the big boy. You were at Jazz Fest this weekend. Now, I believe, were you sick or something that had held you out of Jazz Fest too this long? But, like, because this is your first Jazz Fest experience of the year thus far, right?
Yeah, so this was my first day. I went yesterday. And I kind of, like, I had tickets pretty much. I think somebody gave me tickets for Saturday and Sunday. And I kind of just held out, which I'm happy because Sunday's the best day. It was the last day. It was the closeout day. You had Willie Nelson who had to cancel. And then Zach Brown stepped in. Yeah. Zach Brown Band, which is amazing. Huh. But, yeah, overall, I mean, the best thing about Jazz Fest is that soft shell crab po' boy.
Yes.
It was, man, like, I'll think about that thing for the rest of my life.
So it looked, I mean, I'm not exaggerating. Again, I watched the video right before I went to sleep, and I ended up dreaming about that po' boy. Is that a po' boy worth dreaming about?
Oh, no doubt about it, dude. And because the thing about it is, like, I don't know anybody that makes soft shell crab po' boys at their house.
No.
Or, you know, like, you always got to kind of get that somewhere. And for whatever reason, most people kind of forget about the soft shell crab po' boy.
Yeah.
But, like, no doubt in my mind, that was the best dish that they had at Jazz Fest. I know it. Because it was the longest line. So everybody was trying to get it.
Yeah.
And it was the most expensive thing. It was $15. But, I mean, I forgot about that immediately.
So that's what's interesting, Dev. I was about to ask you this because you are quickly becoming, I mean, your food review videos do numbers. Like, you are quickly becoming, on top of everything else, but, like, known for your takes on delicious New Orleans food. So they didn't hook our guy up with a free softshell po' boy?
Oh, absolutely not.
Damn.
Dude, I'm super, no, yeah,
gotta
no way.
We got to get that change.
No way, but I don't even know how all that happened either because, like, look at me, dude. Like, I'm 165 pounds. you know, it's interesting, man. But, yeah, the food is hitting. Look at the pickles out of that thing. Just pickles and hot sauce, baby. Let's go.
Dev, you should be that guy. Like, you know, like in sports, whenever, you know, somebody does something great, they're like, he'll never have to pay for a meal in Baton Rouge again. Like, that should be you, but in New Orleans. Like, for all the things that you've done for – you know, the red beans and rice every single Monday, but just food in general. The man should never have to pay for a Cajun dish.
I agree.
In New Orleans again.
I agree. And it is picking up a bit, though, Dev, because I do feel like so like with these tickets to Jazz Fest, did somebody kind of come in? Like, were those somebody who enjoys your work?
That's the people on Twitter, man. They're awesome. You know, I always say the best platform in the world is Twitter because, like, the people are so invested on Twitter, you know? Without getting too deep into it, it's just like, I just feel like it's the most loyal platform. You know, when people love you on Twitter, they love you.
Yeah, that's completely fair.
That's actually a good point because it can be a nasty place.
Right. Yeah, like when they hate you, they hate you.
Yeah.
And, okay, so you love Jazz Fest, soft shell po' boy, the highlight of the day. A bit surprised in the Zach Brown Band given the Garth Brooks takes of last week.
I mean, he did like Brad Paisley?
Oh,
here we go.
He did rank Brad Paisley.
Yeah, I mean, Dev, next time we link up, like, we're going to have a full-out conversation about that. But it's okay. It's okay.
And since the day I left Milwaukee, you You got to feel that one, bro.
You were probably feeling it after you spent a night into the morning at a concert with Ben Mintz.
Unbelievable. Because I've never really been to a concert that late, I don't feel like, in a long time at least. And then, you know, Mintz, I'm thinking like, okay, he's just inviting me out to Tipitina's. It's just going to be a good time. It's going to be a decent time, right? Yeah. I'm not expecting...
Vintage jersey on?
I walked out of Miss May's at 7 a.m. and they had a young lady twerking on a Ford Transit van, and I was like, you know, I gotta get the hell out of here. Yeah,
that 12 passenger was had a little life to it.
That was the best Ford commercial I've seen in a long time.
Hey, don't come a rocking when the van is a knocking. Wait, so who did y'all watch though? Because he was full of energy. It looked like a fantastic concert.
Andy Frasco, it was an awesome concert. He was really good. He don't wear shoes. He's barefoot the whole time. He looks like, what's that comedian's name? Eric Andre?
Yes, he looks like when Eric Andre has his long hair, yes. You can see him right here if you're watching on youtube.com/104. Does he have a Lakers jersey on? Did I see that correctly?
Yeah, he's a Lakers fan. That's the only flaw, but he wore Shaquille O'Neal 34, so you can't hate on him.
Yeah, okay. He knew what he was doing there.
Yep, we're good. Shaq jersey always plays.
I have seen him in concert as well. He is really good.
Really?
Yeah. So it was really awesome good show. It really was like I was actually, I shed a tear at the end. It was crazy.
So I'm the only nerd that hasn't seen Andy Frasco. Jeez.
Yeah. And the name, Andy Frasco, man. You know?
Yeah. The top tier name.
Yeah, he tried to hit on my wife and sister-in-law.
Oh,
yeah.
That sounds like another thing about a guy named Andy Frasco. He's going to hit on your wife.
Yeah. And that's fine, though, man. If you hit on my wife, I'm happy. I mean, that, you know.
No, it's like tip of the cap. Like,
yes. I mean, that means I'm doing something right.
You're doing good.
I feel like people are taking that better nowadays. Like, the whole hitting on the wife thing, like, people are just taking it as an immediate sign of, like, respect somehow, which I kind
of
agree with.
It's like a tip of the cap.
Yeah. Now, speaking of top tier, I don't know what this is in reference to, but you texted us Hollywood fighter rankings top five. What are we talking here? Like, who can fight in real life, characters they play?
About, like Snake Bliskin here? What are we talking about?
I mean, to be honest with you, I'm really just talking about Hollywood, like, dudes that were in movies where they were just great with their hands, great fighters.
What spurred this was the incredible Jean-Claude Van Damme sequence that you found from what movie the other day?
And it was awesome. I mean, you think about Saturday morning and you wake up and you watch that. I don't know if there's anything better to watch. I mean, I was ready to run through like 17 walls after that. It was great. But I did a top 15. This is five. Obviously, number one is no argument here, Bruce Lee.
Yeah.
No Steven Seagal.
Yeah. No, bro.
Don't go for Steven Seagal.
Seagal is overrated. I'm with Holden Mayo here, dude.
Let me just tell y'all something. My brother might be driving from Shreveport to have some words. Now.
I mean, look.
Are we kidding?
That's fine, dude. I've never seen Under Siege, so that's fine. But have you ever watched, like, the Steven Seagal video? Like, I know he's an actual black belt, but those videos of him doing martial arts performances.
Jacob hates this list.
No.
Have you seen the videos? The list is good. Seagal just like.
I'm just looking.
Touches the person.
I mean, Wesley Snipes can be a little higher, but I do like the list. I mean, Jean-Claude. I get that. Like, Jean-Claude's great.
Well, and to be fair, like
Dev
said.
Just asking the question.
The Jean-Claude sequence that he's talking about, Jean-Claude Van Damme's on a motorcycle. He decides to go play a game of chicken with a truck. For no discernible reason, he then jumps on top of the motorcycle and starts surfing it and takes out his pistol and blows up the entire truck.
What was this? Was this a movie where his name was like Chance Boudreau?
I can't remember the movie.
There's no way this dude's name was Chance.
Oh, no, there's a movie where Jean-Claude's name is literally Chance Boudreau.
What?
Where was this movie made?
Yeah, if you're watching in studio right now, this
like
is
with the EAUX, like the whole deal.
Yeah, just so if you're listening, I mean, number two, Jean-Claude Van Damme. Number three was Rocky.
Yeah.
Number four, Daniel LaRusso. Number five, Jet Li. I caught a lot of flack for Chuck Norris not being in this, but in my opinion, I just think that Chuck played with too many guns. Dude, he walked around with one for Walker Texas Ranger for years.
Yeah, no.
Oh, this
I
is
know,
by
know,
the way,
I,
this
I,
scene
I,
that I, was Chance Boudreau, by the way.
That is Chance Boudreau.
That is Chance Boudreau.
Good pull, Jake. Another element in Hold the Mayo that we probably didn't even know about there. That's Chance Boudreau on that epic kill. No, I mean, look, here's my deal with Chuck Norris is that Sidekicks is one of my favorite movies of all time. And he is pure martial artist in the Sidekicks movie. And so I don't think I can't really give an objective opinion on Chuck.
Yeah, I'm just on the fence about it.
I would easily bump Jackie Chan above Jet Li. Jackie Chan's a legend. Did all of his own stunts. I'm sure Jet Li did too, but like Jackie Chan's done it. I know, but Jackie Chan.
Well, that was always the argument. Yeah, it was the Jet Li kind of went more in on the stunts. That's what I heard.
Jet Li went more in on stunts than Jackie Chan?
That's what I heard, man. Oh. That's just a rumor right there, but regardless, I mean, I feel like if anybody could get moved up more in this list, it's got to be Uma Thurman.
Kill Bill?
I have not seen a Kill Bill since high school, but she was fantastic. I need to do a Kill Bill rewatch here pretty soon. I'm glad that you put Keanu in there, though.
Oh, there's Jason Statham. I was wondering. Danny's slowly going up the list.
No, but again, to Dev's point, Jason Statham, big gun guy.
Big gun guy.
But also in real life, kind of is too. Is a black belt.
Yeah, yeah. And Keanu in real life is a badass gun guy and martial artist as well. Have you ever seen Dev, have you ever seen the video of Keanu on the actual gun training ranges?
Yeah, he was like flawless. Yes. He was like, yeah, he's like perfect with it. It's actually incredible.
My only other thing here is that Chris Tucker's, you know, really riding some coattails here.
That's a combo, man. That's a combo. So they don't. I don't think Chan really goes without Chris because Rush Hour was so iconic. I gotta put them together there.
And
my main thing with that is if Chris Tucker isn't there, think about the scene when they got all the dudes in the towels. You know, if Chris Tucker isn't there, Jackie Chan gets his ass beat.
Yeah, that's true. Fair. That's fair. I liked when Chris Tucker hit the drop shot. That was the best Chris Tucker action scene when he pulls it out of his boot. And then he's like, clean yourself up. Right afterwards, throws him the little rag. Okay. Mayo, who silenced your notifications? Somebody's upset you, it seems.
Yeah, I just don't understand what's going on with that. That's a new trend, too, just like the horoscopes. You know, everybody's silencing notifications now. I got silenced by like 10 people just the other day.
Now, are you talking about from an iMessage standpoint? Or am I? Because when I go to sleep, my do not disturb kicks on from 10 to 4 and my stuff's silenced.
Yeah, I don't understand. So you ain't getting through to me. Nobody was doing that, but like up until like last year, I feel like.
Yeah, I mean, but you know, I mean, look, man, I don't know. Dude, T-Bob,
you don't respond anyway. So just put the phone face down and put it on silent.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, and what's weird about it is like you'll see the notification that somebody just went on silent and then they'll respond to your message. So it's like, dude, like, are you all in on going on silent or no?
I am. For what it's worth, I am all in. No, that feels like somebody who's screening. It's like you can do the thing where when people call you, the first call goes straight to voicemail automatically. And then the second one goes through.
Hey, can we talk about this Met Gala real quick?
Yeah, what you got?
So the Met Gala, what was that, like a few days ago? And it's just the most interesting thing because, like, I don't understand how they determine who goes there. Like, I saw Amy Schumer there, and she looked like she was just, like I was better dressed at the crib. I was better dressed at the house. And then you see a guy that looks like he works at the Walmart in the fishing department, and it's just like...
Oh, the guy with the red gloves. I kind of love this guy, dude. He looks like an animated Tom Hanks. That's all I can say. Like if you were to do a Pixar movie featuring Tom Hanks, this would be kind of how the actual 3D animation would end up looking. A young Tom Hanks, to be clear.
So much money behind this event, man. That guy shows up in red gloves. I love it.
Red gloves, a button-up, tucked into, like, old, like, 80s jeans.
Because there's nothing really that's expensive about that outfit. That's really just, like, some rubber gloves that, you know, probably some super nice company bought and sold to this guy for, like, $1,000.
Yeah, I mean, exactly. It's like, I was blown away a year ago when Fortnite teamed up with, like, Balenciaga or whatever. And all they did was release like an ugly red T-shirt with Fortnite across the front, and it was like $1,000 for the shirt.
Yeah, but hey, shout out to that guy because I think out of all the outfits I saw, he stole the show.
He stuck with me. I don't remember anybody else. I think I remember maybe Jared Leto looked like he was like part constellation.
3-1 great.
And boy,
oh, that's right. That's right.
Tough time to claim Leto right now, Jake. I feel like Leto stock is just going down, down, down.
Yeah, but 32nd to Mars, bro.
Everybody has
doesn't
fingers.
Look like a constellation right there. Jared Leto looks like a character out of Dune 2. Like I almost guarantee that you will meet him in Dune 2 somewhere along the way.
Yeah.
Morbius.
Ooh,
heard that was not very good.
I know I'm running long here, but I do want to say this about the Breakers because I saw the Breakers talking that, and I think this is the best thing we can do with the Breakers, man. Just keep not watching them because I don't think anybody's watching and they're winning. So that's what I'm gonna keep doing. I still haven't watched the game, and I'm looking at this porcupine picture of Jared Leto right now. That's a wild dude. But I think the Breakers just, I don't know, man. It's one of them teams you just don't watch, man.
So that is the best, like, hometown sports fan logic that I've ever heard is you're inherently rooting for the team because they have your city on their chest, but you don't actually care about them and not watching them. But because they have the city, you want them to win. And it seems like you not watching it is causing them to win, so you're going to continue to not watch the New Orleans Breakers.
Just talk about them the next day.
And then last one here, Dev, the Michael Chandler kick, how about it? Turned him into a caveman.
Unbelievable. Yeah, and I'm sad for Tony Ferguson because he's such a legend in UFC. But, I mean, dude, that was vicious, man. It's just one of those situations where, like, you can't look away. You look away for a second, and, you know, that dude was out. He was out for, like, 7 minutes, dude. It was wild. UFC, man, when it's got stuff like that going on, it's almost like one of the best sports in the world. It's crazy, man. Full house. It's like a gladiator war, you know? I just love the sport.
Yeah, it's I'm still not all the way in on
I don't know why UFC. You always say that.
Well, no. It's not from, like, every time I've sat down and watched it, I've really enjoyed it. I've had a good time. I'm just not in the habit of you know, you gotta get into habits watching stuff, right? It's like anything else in life. And I've never been in the habit of, like, ooh, it's Saturday night, let's turn on the fight. Maybe I'll get there. We'll see.
But no, it was an epic kick. I mean, look at the guy's face, man. Look at that, crazy, man. He looks like a Tootsie Roll.
He looks like an NFT.
He looks like an NFT.
Yeah,
he does. NFT, dude. Yeah. Oh my god.
That's what he looks like.
If you just do some, like, pixel art, if you just did, like, a pixelated version of that, absolutely. Somebody would try to sell you that for, like, $50,000.
The size of that man's thigh, man.
Exactly. Yeah. Mayo, that's what jumped out to me, bro. That is a man. Chandler does not skip leg day. Look at the power, because that quad is fully flexed, throwing this kick along with his hips. Look at the power coming out of that quad.
Oh, I mean, yeah, he looks like he's got, like, something living in there. That thing is, and it's a full extension, too. Oof. Full extension.
Kind of makes me a little hungry, actually. I can't really explain it. Yeah.
I think I know where you're going with that. It's almost like you could bite in, like, to, like, a leg of chicken right there.
Ooh, yeah. Oh,
and that's, like, the meat. That's the meat part
right
there.
That's the meat part right there.
Yeah, that's it.
Between that and the soft shell crab ho boy, your boy is starving now. Mayo, thank you so much, man. What's on the docket for RB&R Day today?
Just another day of tradition. Not sure where we're going yet, but we always find a spot. And, yeah, man, let's do it. Also, rest in peace, Scuttlebutt, man, the old pink brick-and-mortar strip club in Slidell. What a sad day, man.
Wait, so had you been there, Mayo? Had you been to
Scuttlebutt? I've never been there, but I feel like I've been there a bunch. Never been there, though.
Okay, so I want to also inform you of something that is absolutely wild that Emil McClellan just told us in the chat that was learned on Desus and Mero. That dude in the red gloves, I don't know how this is true, but he is saying that entire outfit was made of leather.
Oh my god.
Which makes sense now, which makes a little more sense in terms of why you do that. But saying that entire outfit was made of leather, that is wild if that is actually the case. We will work to confirm.
Yeah, because
that.
It looks like he got it from he looks like he just picked up that outfit from, like, Home Depot.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's it. That is wild.
You learn something new every day here on Spread Lines. Mayo, thank you so much, man.
All right. Take care, boys.
Holodev, later. More. Can you believe that? All that was made of leather. It's like, is it cake? But is it leather?
Yeah, that's actually fascinating. Is it cake? Think, yeah.
Is it cake's pretty good.
Yeah, it's good.
All right, when we get back, more OTB.
OTB. OT. In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
There it is, the extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz vans.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
And this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA-certified techs. Family-owned and operated by the Sherman family for 30 years, front-to-back is the answer in Baton Rouge for all of your custom boat needs. So head to front-to-backboatservice.com or find them on Facebook, Front-to-Back Boat Service.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
For a Monday edition of Early Line, as we talk to Jeff Sheesby of the Action Network and look ahead to the night's action in the NBA playoffs, and we recap the weekend that was. Join us for Early Line, 2 to 3 p.m., 104.5 ESPN, Baton Rouge. Our Lady of the Lake Ascension and 100.7 The Tigers Swamp Pop Music Fest and Jambalaya Cook-Off is Saturday, June 25th from 12 p.m. to 9 p.m. at Lamar Dixon. Thanks to our title sponsor, Our Lady of the Lake Ascension, Jambalaya Cook-Off sponsor Mike Ward's Liberty Safes, and presenting sponsor Supreme Chevrolet. All the proceeds from the Jambalaya plate sales will go to Alzheimer's Services. For the lineup of bands and to purchase tickets, go to 1045ESPN.com.
OTB OT with Hester and T-Bob on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
Apparently, Desus Mero also made the is it cake joke. I want to be painfully clear. I did not see that episode. Desus Mero, they're great, they're hilarious. I actually never really watched after they got off of ice for some reason. I don't know why, but I did not see that joke. In case you're listening, and there was randomly talk earlier in the chat about Carlos Mencia and joke stealing. So I want to be like
Carlos Mencia.
I want to be aggressively clear that I did not steal that joke. Carlos Mencia, another reason why Mexico's way down right now. between Mencia, Canelo, the U.S. or the soccer Mexican national team. It's just it's a tough day for your boys, Danny. Tough day for the boys. That's all I'm saying. Nothing to say?
Yeah, anything to say.
He pulled the mic over in front of his face.
I mean, because there's no point. I mean, like, Mexico's ranked in the top 10. U.S. is not.
Yeah, Jake, explain that one to me. How did that happen?
So, that one to me.
Oh, nothing to say there, huh?
No, I got
I'm trying to tee up.
That one to me doesn't make sense because if you look at the form, their record, U.S.'s record in the last 15 is better than Mexico's, including three victories.
Yeah.
And a draw against Mexico.
Yeah.
So I'm not real sure where that one comes from. I don't know, Danny, and this isn't rhetorical. The injuries come into play in that? Like Weston McKennie being down, maybe Gio Reyna being down. Does that, I mean, I guess. I don't know.
Okay, Carlos Mencia is from Honduras. So that's on
me. Way to be racist.
That
hands
is
up.
Very.
Hands up. That's on
very,
me. That's racist. That's on me.
Very, very.
I apologize.
Very.
I just went Latin
very
country.
Bad.
I took a shot. I apologize.
You're like the reporter guy.
Okay, well, guess what? The George Lopez show. Okay, no one really thinks that show's
whoa,
funny.
Bro. Whoa. There's a lot of like 50-year-olds that still enjoy. Actually, 6 years.
I'm not gonna lie, it was.
I'm
on
pretty sure my dad like loved it.
It was on in studio the other day, and I was like, "Huh, looks like it looks like a pretty good time." Lopez and his family just kind of going through, and I could tell it was one of those heavier episodes where the comedy deals with some actual issues. And I think it was about one of the family members becoming a citizen. It looked pretty good. Okay, that's on me. I'll take this L.
Yeah.
Mexico's still down, but not down as big as I thought because Carlos Mencia is actually Honduran.
I just wanted to listen to the George Lopez theme song. It was a good one.
This was our George Lopez rider. Theme song? Mm-hmm. This is Low Rider.
Yeah. This was a George that Lopez the theme song. I'm watching the
right,
intro
I know,
video.
But like, I don't think it deserves to be called a George.
I yeah, that, no, I agree with Jake here as well.
I'm sorry, but that's what I know it as.
I do like, though,
really?
That...
like, you don't... Like, Gone in 60 Seconds, like...
I didn't know this song before George Lopez.
I do not remember George Lopez. Really? Gone. Oh, no. Okay, you're talking Low Rider.
Yeah.
I didn't think George Lopez was in that movie. In the George Lopez intro, they're jumping on a trampoline in slow motion. Am I correct here?
Yes.
Okay, I do remember that. I have nothing else to add. I just remember that.
It was an okay show, I thought. It wasn't terrible. It wasn't great.
Okay, everybody's coming. Okay, yes, I deserve this all. I deserve this all in the chat. Okay, when we get back. Let's
tough
try to get
scene
it together.
For T-Bob here.
Happy Mother's Day to the Pelicans rookies' moms. There's a great article in The Advocate today about Trey Murphy's mom and Herb's mom and Jose Alvarado's mom and like what it was like watching their kids do what they did this year. It's really sweet. I'd really recommend going to check it out. It's a great piece. I think Rod Walker might have done it. Sorry if I'm wrong there. You know what's crazy? Jose Alvarado's mom, Odelia, was 16 years old when she had Jose. And look at this man now. Look at this man now doing it in the NBA against all odds. All right, when we get back, Ask the Bench, brought to you by Cole Kerr's Life, is here until the Blue Moon.
OTB, OT.
Go to Central Plumbing, centralplumbing.org, 925-8552, 925-8552. Weekend, weekday, holiday, it doesn't matter. Central Plumbing is there for you no matter what. Emergency service 24/7. Yeah, I'm getting roasted. Right now, I'm getting roasted. I'm getting broken. And if I was a toilet as broken as I am right now, I would call Central Plumbing. They've been at it for 50 years. They come out of my home. They'd have flat rate pricing. They'd be licensed, bond insured. Great warranty coverage once the work is done. And my plumbing issues would be taken care of.
Centralplumbing.org is the website. Remember, it's not only in emergency services. Bathroom remodels, they can come out, they can take a look at what you've got currently, and they can upgrade it. They can give you new floors, a new shower, a new tub, a new vanity, whatever it might be, they can handle that. Also, if you want to go tankless, and that tankless water heater that literally never runs out of hot water, they can install that as well. Centralplumbing.org.
Can't believe it.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
There it is, the extra mile. on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care. It's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
If home is where the heart is, a roof is a shield. That's why for over 25 years, South Louisiana always turns to Garcia Roofing and Sheet Metal. For more information, visit GarciaDidMyRoof.com.
Matt Moscona wishing all the moms a happy Mother's Day weekend and inviting you to join us for Monday's AFR presented by Relief Windows. We'll recap LSU-Bama from Tuscaloosa. Join us Monday, 3 to 6, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
OTB OT with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
All right, I'm getting roasted in the chat again. They call me T-Y-D. Scott Dice say my dad's Argentinian. Does that make me Mexican? I deserve all this. I deserve all this. Good learning lesson for your boy. Won't do it again. Won't do it again.
Real quick, yeah, because I'm not going to piggyback on that. Oof. TV ratings. We were talking about the USFL. So
yeah.
This is prime time on Saturday. ABC had NBA basketball. It was 3.89 million. CBS had NCIS, 1.93 million. The CW had Would I Lie to You? I don't know what that is. It had 300,000 viewers. You had, let's see, NBC had Dateline NBC, had 3.38 million viewers. And Fox had USFL football had 990,000.
I still don't think they're upset with that. I don't know. I would need some sort of context, but I feel like they're hitting a milli. They're probably feeling pretty good. But
I don't know. I don't know. It's Big Fox, and so it's like Big Fox.
Yeah, maybe not.
I don't know.
But then again, I mean, how about NCIS? What? It's on a rerun Saturday too. Afternoon rerun, catching over a mil.
Yeah.
I didn't know Dateline still existed, honestly, too.
Apparently, people are watching killing it, almost as much. I think actually it was more right at the NBA playoffs.
Ask the bench. Preference, venison fried steak, chicken fried chicken, or regular chicken fried steak?
Oh, my gosh. All? Everything?
All of them are good.
I love venison, though.
Fried chicken overall.
I love it. I'll go venison. Love Innocent.
Craig Granger, strip club buffet, overrated or underappreciated?
No chance in hell.
Underappreciated.
I've never eaten one.
Me neither.
But I know if you're in Atlanta, actually the food's supposed to be pretty fantastic. Ask the bench, from a player's point of view, what situation would be harder to get over, losing via the Minneapolis Miracle or losing 28-3? After being up. 28-3 because it's in the Super Bowl.
28-3. I don't know. That Baltimore Ravens Hail Mary still eats at me.
Yeah, I could see that. Why does T-Bob diss Hispanic people? I'm sorry. Again, I don't. I love my Southern brethren. It's the bench. Are we not going to talk about T-Bob's hot take on Friday, talking about paying for Arch Manning's sperm?
What?
Yeah, no, it was during the Saturday Kentucky Derby show. I was going to say, if you could stud Archie Manning, how much would you pay? At least a mil. Probably more.
OTB. OT.
Bruh.
What do you own today?
You don't think that? Think about it. You don't think that you would, or that people would. Go to Page Plus Urgent Care, PagePlusUC.com, PagePlusUC.com. 8 locations here in Baton Rouge, 9 overall. For all of life's unexpected moments, if you've never been inside of a Patient Plus, we'll find the one nearest to you. And next time you're feeling a little sick or something goes wrong, like you burn your hand like I did, go in and you are going to be blown away. The facilities are second to none. Also, the technology, right? You make a digital profile. It's so easy to check in and check out. And if you need your occupational medicine needs met for a business, they are the best, and it's all at the Mid-City location. Go to PatientPlusUC.com.
And whether it's sneezing season or another minor illness or injury that has you down, Patient Plus is always there to help. They've done it for T-Bob when he burned his hand. They've done it for me with the boys. If they need stitches, if they've got a cold, whatever it might be, and there's going to be a location that is convenient to you in the Baton Rouge area. Also, speaking on convenience, 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. every single day, PatientPlusUC.com. Get in and get better.
Follow us on Twitter at 1045ESPN to cast your vote in the Citizens Bank and Trust poll of the day. Vote daily inside Off the Bench, Hunts and Hill, The Early Line. And after further review, Citizens Bank and Trust brings you the poll of the day via Twitter at 1045ESPN.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
If you're in a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law office of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.